Can you hear me?
Oh, we're. Hey, good evening, everybody. We're coming to you from Lake Worth High School campus. There come your Pirates running through the tunnel getting ready for this game tonight. I'm sitting here, I'm Jimmy Heffernan. I'm sitting here with Danny Guidry.
Hello, everybody.
And we got a beautiful evening, beautiful evening here. Sun's just going down. Got a little wind going from left to right now. Coin toss already happened. It looks like the Lake Worth Bullfrogs are going to be receiving the opening kickoff. So your Granbury Pirates will be on defense first. Set the tone.
Mr. Heffernan and I are sure glad to be here tonight. Thanks to the Granbury Pirate Production Company for letting us substitute for Mr. Euchre tonight. Can't guarantee we're going to be the best, but we'll definitely have as much fun as we possibly can, right?
We're going to have fun one way or another.
That's right.
We'll see what happens. They may fire us by halftime, but you know, hey, we'll give it a try here. Coach Barnes getting ready, getting our kickoff team set, ready to go.
Sunset.
All righty. Now, folks, follow at home. Last week, Coach Shahan gave us a new war cry when we kicked off and do a pirate yell and a little boom at the end of it. So we're gonna try to make Coach Shahan proud and see what we can do here. All right, you ready here? All right, here we go. Boom! There we go. A kick. Looks like it's gonna come down about the 10-yard line, 23 for Lake Worth Bullfrogs. Get it. Scampering up through. Looks like he got all the way up
down
to the
39-yard
line.
You know, in talking to defense, it's just control the controllables. Do your job. He feels like this season they're deeper in each position than they've ever been before.
We had a little mic trouble. I guess they had to mute some of that. All right, they're going to line up. One back in the backfield, three wide outs. There you go. Looks like number three. On the keeper. Strung him out wide. Number three for us. Number three, Josh McGinnis comes up, makes the tackle from his safety spot right there. Great job by the line of stringing that out. Be able to feel. Looks like it's going to be second down and 10. No gain on the play.
That was a great job of containment there.
We got twins. One man in the backfield, got motion. Quarterback keeper right up the middle. Had a little room there, but it closed pretty quickly right there. Who was that on that tackle there, Coach Guidry?
Looks like number 45.
All right, 45. Here we go.
I'm Chase Cantrell.
Chase Cantrell. All right, looks like we're going to have second down. Looks like about second down and six here. Then we're going to go rise up right here. They're going to go with the twin set, one back in the backfield again. Got a little got motion going again. From right to left. Come back off, get a call from the sideline. Here we go.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Step back, pass, quick pass over the middle.
Oh, and he missed it.
Oh, through.
That's
number 11 for them. Caden Duhon. Looked like he had a moment there and went right through his hand. Number 12 for us defending was Christian Paddock. So it's going to be down fourth down and six.
Fourth down and six.
Who's deep for us? Number six, Austin Main back
is
to
back
receive the punt.
Back to receive.
That's a great opening stop by the Pirate defense to get us moving in the right direction here.
Uh-oh.
Looks like we might have a little delay of game.
We'll take that 5 yards.
Yes, it was a delay of game on the Lake Worth Bullfrogs right there. So now it moves it back to fourth and 11. Gives an extra 5 yards right there.
Get the ball back here with pretty good field position.
With that wind blowing left to right, this thing should hang up, not carry very far. Oh, it's a fake.
Fake.
He's got a guy down the sideline.
Oh, and he missed him.
They had a guy, number six, punter.
Now we're set
number
up
six,
a really
Jose
good
Meza. He threw a good pass right there, just kind of overthrew his receiver, had his receiver streaking down the sideline. Looking for the Pirates, kind of overthrew him there. So now the Pirates are going to get great field position. It's going to be first and 10 on the Lake Bullfrog 38-yard line. Starting in positive territory on the first drive.
Yeah, that's an interesting move to try to fake punt right off the bat.
I think they just said they had a sense that maybe sneak one in there, try to score some points early. Got Hayden Meyer under center. Jaden Rogers under.
Tyler Rogers on the
hands
run.
Hands off to Tyler
there he
Rogers.
Goes. There he's
the
going. He's gone. He's gone.
And that's going to be a touchdown on the first play of scrimmage.
That is a touchdown.
38-yard rush by Tyler Rogers. Great job by the left side of the line, creating a big crease over there to open up that hole for him. So it looks like the linebackers kind of slid with that motion and were kind of keying on Jaden there. And the next thing you know, handed it to Tyler right up the middle.
Weston Cantrell here for the extra point.
With a try. Snap was a little low. We got it down, and Cantrell somehow.
How did he pick that ball?
I don't know how he got it. He got it up off the ground and got that. I don't know how he got it through, but he got it through. And so now your Pirates are up with 10-12 left in the first quarter. Your Pirates are up 7-0 on a.
That's a pretty good start for the Pirates.
So Tyler Rogers had three touchdowns last week, so he's just adding on to his total right there.
He's becoming legendary quick.
Yeah. So
I tell you what, in talking to Coach Galindo, their goal in tonight's game was to have 600 yards of rushing offense.
600 yards of rushing offense. Well, we're off to a good start. One play, 38 yards.
I would say we're off to a heck of a start.
Hey, if they can average 38 yards a play, I think we got a chance.
We have a chance.
Yeah.
Weston Cantrell back here to kick again.
You're going to get into the action on this on the Pirate War Chant right here at the kickoff, Coach Guidry, since they had a little mic problem last time.
Mic problem. It's going to be okay. We're going to be fine here.
All right, here we go.
Here we go. Boom!
There we go.
Now
that he got it deep into that wind, got it about the 3 yard line. He takes it. Here he comes up the right, going up the middle. Oh, number one right there met him right there at the 15 yard line. Augie Zapata stood him up, and
Jimmy, that's going to leave a mark.
Yeah, that's going to leave a little mark because Augie had a little momentum when he stuck his face mask right in that kid's chest. That kid's going to remember him.
He will remember that.
It looks like they gave him forward progress to about the 17-yard line.
It'd be really nice here if we could get the ball back quickly, maybe force a little turnover here deep in their territory.
They're going to go trips right, single wide out to the left, one back in the backfield with the quarterback. Here we go. We're going to go straight up the middle. Quarterback going to follow as kind of a lead for the quarterback. He's going to get up to about the 25-yard line, so he's going to pick up about 8 on first down. I missed who got us on the tackle there. It was a whole bunch of people, a whole bunch of white shirts.
A whole lot of Pirates.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going twins to both sides. Here we go.
Hand off again.
Yeah, hand off again. Looks like number 90 was in on the stop. Worth Bullfrog sucked into the middle, and then Jaden Rogers just was able to walk into the end zone from 12 yards out. Yeah, so Jaden Rogers now, he's going to add to his total. He had one last week, and now there's one now. Here we go. We're going to, for the try after, it's going to be Cantrell again. Number 4 holding. Oh, a little better snap, a little better hold. Yeah,
good. We're good.
He hit that. He hit that one well. Let's see. White. What do we got? Yeah, it's White Riddle. It's a holder. He did a great job on the first PAT, just getting that snap and getting it on the ground. And that one, a little bit easier. He got it down. Cantrell hits it almost to the building. Just under six minutes gone in the first quarter. Your Pirates are leading 14-0 right now. Lake Worth Bulldogs have tried to go for it, tried to fake punt, and they tried to go for it on 4th-and-1. And both times defense rose up, made a play, gave our offense a short field, and offense took advantage of that short field.
Yeah, you know, this game is really easy when you're playing on a short field. If we can play the field position game like this all night, it ought to be in our favor.
We might have a chance at some of those rushing totals and point totals and everything else. As you can hear, we have the Pride of Granbury marching band right below us.
I try it under the direction of Mr. Morales. He does a fantastic job with our program.
Right to the left of them. We're looking right there at the stowaways. And we got the cheerleaders right down there. They're right in front of us, going from about 45 to 45. So here we go.
All right, guys, we got to hear you at home. We got to hear this at home.
Let's go.
Okay?
Here we go. Boom. There we go. It's another good kickoff to the right side of the field.
Fumble.
He dropped the ball on the kick. Kind of good job by the Pirates right there. They're staying in the lane. Looks like number 13, number 42. At number 45. So that's going to be Taj Clayton.
So number 23, Arian, just had a little mishap there with the ball. Yeah. Sure did give us a chance to get good field position again.
Brian Steven and Chase Cantrell all combined on that stop right there. It was a good job by the Pirates not to collapse on that. And they stayed in their lanes, didn't give him much room to go. So Lake Worth Bullfrogs will start on their own 17-yard line. They're going to go trips right, single back in the backfield. Still got number 3 at quarterback. Got a little shift by the defensive line. There we go. We're going to a little quick pass out to the right. Oh, great job getting off a block and slowing that down. Let's see, who was that? Number 9 out there? Number 9, Cameron James. Did a great job. They tried to shield him. That middle receiver tried to shield him off. He did a great job of getting around that and slowing that down for the rest of the Pirate posse to get there.
Yep, giving our backfield time to get in place.
There, so now, sitting there with the 2nd and 10. Bullfrog Bulldogs right there. They're going to try to roll out to the right. A little pass downfield.
Short, number got interception.
Right there.
Interception.
Oh, right there.
Peyton Burns.
Peyton Burns set right there. Played his position very well. Quarterback rolled out, tried to throw it right there. Peyton Burns had tight coverage on it. Didn't really give him much of a window to throw in. And then he kind of just forced it in. And Peyton said, no, I don't think so. Not tonight. That's going to be my ball.
That's my ball. And that gives us great field position again for our third possession.
I know. So now we're going to start on the Bullfrog 22-yard line, running that flex bone out again. So we got
Tyler Rogers in the backfield.
We got Jaden Rogers at the right wing and Jeffrey Leonard at the left wing. We'll be up under center. Jeff Leonard went in motion. Oh, nice pitch right
nice
there. That's
pitch.
A great job. It looks like it's a race to the pylon, and that's not much of a race right there. That was Jaden Rogers right there for a second touchdown of the night for Jaden.
You know, what a great thing about this offense, Jimmy, is you just never know who's going to get the ball, and it's so hard to defend that if you don't stay disciplined on defense.
Yeah, right there, Jeff Leonard went in motion, and they kind of collapsed, thinking we were going to go to the right side of the offense, and then we went back left right there. Cantrell, little snap. There we go. We're up again.
And it's great.
Three touchdowns, three tries after, and it's 21-0 with 5:06 left in the first quarter.
This could be a long night.
Yeah.
Fighting Bullfrogs.
Well, you know, right now we're just leaping over the Bullfrogs right now. It's a great job. Hey, once again, you got to give the big boys up front, the offensive line, credit. They're creating some space right there and handling the line of scrimmage. And then now at the point of attack, they're making the guy make a decision. That time the defensive end decided he would crash down on Hayden Meyer. And so all he did was just pitch it out to Jaden and said, okay, why don't you go walk into the end zone?
And you said it best. It really does start out with the front. I mean, you got Whipple, you got Reed, Quist, those guys. They just do a fantastic job of
Enrique Sanchez.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. They're clearing space and giving our backs a place to find a hole.
And again, this offense is just very tough to defend. Coach Otten was a brand new coach in this year. He's just done a fantastic job of pound and ground offense.
Yeah, he's done it. Yeah, he's done a great job. All right, here we go. Let's hear you at home now, folks. Let's go.
Boom!
There we go, right there. Now, he drove that thing to the back of the end zone.
That's gonna be a
touchback. Hey.
This may be
Weston Cantrell also stars for our soccer team once football's over, so doing a good job there. Now Bullfrogs Well, no, the first possession they had it out there about the 34, 39.
You're right. My fault.
We're gonna go twins again. Their Bullfrogs gonna try on their fourth possession. Got number five in motion. They're gonna hand it to him on a little sweep around. He found the edge. He got up to, and the little yellow hanky came flying out.
We have a flag. I think that's
got a flag on the play. I'm afraid we might have he got out. He got out to about the 43-yard line. We're going to see what the call is. But the way that kind of went down, it almost like they're going to get us for out, hitting him out of bounds. Yeah, that's exactly what they got us for.
That's going to be a 10-yarder.
A 15.
15.
That's going to give them 15 yards. That's the first time the Bullfrogs have seen the positive side of the field. They're going to be on the Granbury 46. They're going to go with a little tempo here, try to get things moving and stuff. A little quick pass out here to number five. He's going to try to get around the corner. Oh, right there. We got him out of bounds right there. It's going to get down to about the Granbury 40-yard line.
That was really close there. That was really close right there. for another unnecessary roughness, so I'm glad we didn't get called on that.
It was almost close to a little holding penalty out here on number 13. Looked like he had a hold of Hayden Burns, not quite letting him go. They're going to try to go right up the middle. It doesn't look like, let's see, initial contact. Slowed it down, spun him around a little bit. It looks like 33.
Josh Clayton got it as part of that.
Okay, so great job coming up making that play. So it's going to be third down and two, about a long two for the Bullfrogs.
Here so we go. Got Damian Hopkins in here as quarterback for the Lake Worth Bullfrogs now. Yeah, trying to change it up.
He's going to try to take it himself right up the middle. Found a little hole. Got a post of Pirates getting there.
Tackle was made by Robin Brennish on that one, number 20.
You know, the Bullfrogs found a little, have found a couple of creases here. Now, hey, it's all right. Hey,
the penalty didn't help us, Jimmy.
The penalty did not help us, but you know what? I have a feeling right now our Pirates are about to bow their neck and start making it a little tough.
Make sure you drink your water, man. Drink lots of water.
So they're staying in that twin set a lot tonight.
Jose
number
Mason
five
back
in motion.
In
they're going to step back. They're going to throw. He's looking. Number 33.
Oh, he dropped it.
Number 33 with the pressure on the quarterback right there. Number 33 is Sam Sutherland. He had a little pressure on the quarterback, and the quarterback pushed it out there. He had a guy open, but it hit. Bad thing about it was is hit him right in the hands, but he just couldn't bring it in. So that helps the Pirates out. We're second and 10. They're going to go with the trips left here. Pirates got a little shift on defense. Standing up. They're stepping back, trying to throw another little screen out here. Number five.
Oh.
He slipped the tackle. He got down to the Pirate 25-yard line. It looks like we're going to be about third and one to go. So right here, Pirates need a big stop right here.
Yeah, we got to bow our neck here. We got to show them that we're back in this thing. We can't rest on our laurels.
He's going to try to take it right up the middle. He found a little hole. That's time.
First down.
Number six, Austin Main, comes up from the safety position. Cuts his legs out from under him. So now,
first and 10 at the 19.
We're trips right. They're trying to spread us out just a little bit and find it. Looks like Coach Lindo wants a timeout. He wants to talk about it just a minute. Give our boys just a break. Looks like they found the light switch and flipped the lights on as the sun's starting to fade in the distance. But we're standing up here. We're standing up here on top of the visitor press box. We got a nice breeze on this night. Scott Hayes goes, how long were you hanging on to leaping over the Bullfrogs? Anyway.
Make sure you're drinking water, please.
Oh, we're back live. Here we go. We got a first and 10 on the Pirate 19-yard line. Bullfrogs right there. They're going to step back. They're going to make another throw. They got a man on.
Oh, and he missed him again.
They were trying a little swing route out of. Had a guy who was going to swing out right there, brought a little slant in from the outside, and we're going to swing him down the sideline, just kind of overthrew him.
Yeah, if we would have hit that guy, that would have been six for sure.
Yeah, but we're – so as it is, the pass was a little inaccurate, so we're now second and 10. Both teams – it looks like both teams want to establish the run game. That's going to be their primary mode of transportation. They're going to go on the ground instead of through the air.
And they think they're just – I think they're just trying to really spread us out as thin as we can.
Yeah. There we go. Stepping back. He's going to – steps up. He sees the man in there. He's a little high. Had number five streaking through the end zone. That was Cornell Avington, wide receiver streaking through the end zone. Just stepped up and just settled a little bit. He's thrown into that wind. Thought he had to put a little extra on it.
And, you know, that wasn't a bad route.
It was just a little off
on the throw.
All right, so now we got a third and 10 at the 19-yard line. It's time for the Pirates to get a stop here. Here we go. we're going to step back. Got a twins. Got number five going in motion again. Going to go over to Tripp's right. He's going to step back. Oh. Looking a little screen pass. Oh, wow.
Wow. That was read. That was read nicely.
Perfectly.
Like by Rylan Brennish, number 20. He read that the whole way. He was sitting on there. And all, Rylan was almost wearing a green jersey. He read that so well.
Here we go.
Looks like the Bullfrogs. Yeah, that was a loss of 2 yards right
fourth
there.
Fourth down and 11.
Yeah, so as is the Bullfrogs moniker tonight, they're going to go for it on fourth down.
And why wouldn't you?
Exactly. So they're going to step back. He's going to step up. Got a man down the sideline right there. There you go. It was a great job by Hayden Burns recognizing that guy was going to try to streak down the sideline, started covering ground quick. Ball hit him right in the back as he was making that recovery.
Hit him in his numbers.
So it's going to be first down and 10 for your Pirates as we starting on their own 21-yard line.
Now we get to see the offense in action.
We're going to get to see the offense run a few plays here this time. Well, we think, you know, I mean, hey.
Last week Tyler Rogers made this kind of deal in one play.
Yeah, so here we go. We're sitting there. We got two receivers to the left side of our offense right there. Our flex bowl, Nate Myers, Jaden Rogers is going right there. Tyler Rogers right up the middle, keeps turning his legs with the big boys pushing along. Looks like he got all the way up to the 26-yard line, so that's going to be a gain of about 5 yards for the Pirates. So, hey, right there, that's all right. If we want to just keep pounding that ball at them like that, we just want to keep pounding. That's going to wear their legs out.
Well, you can tell they're just trying to load the box and Harris to throw it.
They're putting everybody within about 5 yards of line of scrimmage. There we go. Bullfrogs did a little bit better job of defending that. We still got 1 yard out of it, so it's going to bring down the third and four for the Pirates.
This is one of those, it could go either way on this deal.
I think we've probably been wearing them out on that corner, so you're probably going to see some kind of option right there, see what we can get going. See if we can get them at the point of attack on the outside right there. Uh-oh, we got a look like we're going to run a little bit of an option. We got a false start. It looks like it's going to be a false start on the Pirates. So that's going to take the Pirates to a 3rd and 9 now.
That changes things a little bit, changes the play call.
It looked at that point, looked like they were going to crash down, try to get the ball out of Hayden Myers' hand as quick as possible, and he had a pitch to Jaden, and it was going to be one-on-one, Jaden one-on-one on the guy at the corner, and, you know, I've seen Jaden run for the last 3 years. I'd give him the benefit of the doubt right there that he's going to win that one.
No question.
My money would be on him. So third
we got Riley Carter out there.
Right there.
Oh, we got another flag.
Looks like we got another flag on the play. Pitch was kind of behind Jaden. He just he had to slow down just a little bit, but I think that flag did not stop the play, so we might get an offsides on the old Bullfrogs right there. Bullfrog coach is waving. He wants to decline it, so it's on us. Still haven't seen. We had an illegal formation right there, so they declined it. So it's going to bring down, it's going to bring up fourth and four. Well, it's going to bring down about 4th and 11 for the Pirates. So they're going to go ahead and kick. Got about 51 seconds left.
For three. Two
and a half. So who's? Is that 29 back to punt for us? Hayden Burns back to punt for us. And they got deep. I think it's number 5 deep for them. So, uh-oh.
Oh, no.
They just got the Pirates. We took a little bit too much time on the play clock. We got one play clock that said 40 seconds on the left end zone. We got another play clock at 25. I'm not sure which one they're using, but we got a delay game on the Pirates. So that's going to bring
up. Jimmy evidently was 25.
All right. It really doesn't matter because the guy on the field is the one that keeps the official one.
That's right.
So that's it. That's now a 4th and 16. The Pirates already set the punt. Hayden back deep, takes a snap. Here we go. Boom. It's an end over end punt. Number five takes it, shoots up the middle right there. We had a hand on him, but didn't get him down. Number six, Halston Main.
Losing yardage.
He keeps going backwards. So Halston Main spun him around, and then number 13, Taj Clayton, finished him off. I think Taj originally had kind of slowed him down, and then he took off again and got spun around, went backwards. So it'll be a first down for the Lake Worth Bullfrogs on their own 49-yard line, but there's another flag on the play, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, let's see what this is. We're all of a sudden getting flag happy.
They're going to get us for another illegal formation, it looks like, right there, Coach Guidry. So so that's going to move it from their 49 to our 46. Still, it's just first down. Sorry about that, folks.
It's
All right, so now.
You know, Lake Worth's offensive line is pretty big boys.
They got a couple of big boys right there. Right here, this left tackle is a pretty good sized kid. They're going trips right there. Single back in the backfield. Number three still at quarterback. 33 seconds left in the first quarter. Ball's been whistled in play. Uh-oh, number five in motion. They're going to give him a little sweep out there. Oh! I'm not sure number one didn't get taken down. Who's number one for us?
Number one, that's Augie Zapata.
Augie Zapata, it looked like the receiver might have grabbed him around the neck, and it looks like number 33, Sam Southern, was out there on the tackle also. So that was a first down run for the Bullfrogs.
Yeah,
so
Cornell Abington, he's really giving us a hard time. He's slippery.
Yeah, he's quick. He can move. He's got some moves right there. Number three right up the middle. They're going with the single back right up the middle. Got about 2 yards on the play, so it's going to bring second down and eight.
One, and that's it. Five, six, ready, go.
So that was another tackle by Augie Zapata.
Okay. There we go. We got about a second eight right here. Oh.
Now we're at the end of the quarter. At the end of the first quarter, guys, we have Pirates 21. Lake Worth Bullfrog 0.
I guess. Hey, we hadn't been fired yet, so we're good.
Yeah,
Hey, did you like my light switch?
Oh, I love it. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Yeah. All right. So now we're back in. We're back live, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. We're trips left. About a second eight, start of the second quarter.
The second
Pirates 38-yard line. Number six back to pass. Sees a little stop and go. There's pressure on him. He's not going to get free from that. Looks like Augie Zapata had him around the ankles. Whole defensive line kind of caved in on that. He was looking for a little stop and go out of his middle receiver, but that was not defense. Our secondary set on that, and then so he thought he was going to slide up the middle, but our line was.
Yeah, our defensive backs there stayed in their alley.
All right, so third down and seven. Here we go. We got a little reverse. Oh, no. A little
double reverse.
Double reverse with the pass.
Wide
and
we're
going to go back to
him. Oh, and he finally caught one.
That was. Hey. It came a little reverse, and then we came off that guy. When we came off that guy, they threw it back to him down that left sideline.
I guess you call that a reverse flea flicker, huh?
That was a little bit of a reverse flea flicker. I'm struggling with the words. I don't know that I said flea flicker right, but you know, hey.
Flea flicking frog?
Hey.
Let's go with that.
There we go. You're going to offend the Lake Worth people.
No, they're fine. Everything's great.
Oh, okay. Looks like they're going to line up the kick. Number 24.
is Humberto Carranza going through the motions, and it looks like
he
snuck it right through that right upright. So now, with 11-12 to go in the second quarter, in the first half, your Pirates are up 21-7. Hey, it's time for us to go ahead and get the ball back, and this time we'll get the ball back and just take it on a nice long drive. Big boys up front.
Hey, yeah, we just need to reset just a little bit. It's going to be fine.
Hey, I feel our big boys up front are going to take care of the stuff. Yeah. All right, so this time it's going to be the Pirates receiving the ball. All right, looks like Jaden Rogers is going to be back deep. Then we're going to have Tyler Rogers right here on there, and then Halston Main. Yeah, it looks like Jaden and Halston are going to go deep. Yeah.
Train. Here we go.
All right. Hey, we can go ahead and do our boom here too on this.
Hey,
kickoff.
Why not?
Hey, because you know when we say boom, that ball is going to be in the air, and then we're going to look for one of our guys to take that thing.
But I'm not sure Mason should do that here, Jimmy. I'm not sure we should do the boom on their kick. I just think that's something.
You know what? All right. So we won't do the boom on their
kick. We got a train going over here anyway.
Okay. Van's got a little train going. It looks like he's going to go to
Austin Main. Oh.
Came off his hands a little bit. Picked it up in the end zone. Now he's dancing for some yards. It looks like he's going to get stopped around the 15-yard line.
Yep.
That ball was kind of a line drive, and it looked like it was going to come down, but that wind just kept taking it and kind of got over his shoulder and just tipped off his hand.
That was a good recovery, though. That could have been a disaster.
It could have been disastrous, but he made a great recovery. So our big boys up front now. Here we go. What we got? We got Diesel Dooley over there at right tackle, my mic was messed up. Sorry about that. Got Jeff Leonard in motion. We're going to step back. We're going to throw a quick pass over here. Oh, that was a great catch. Hey, it looked like we had the Bullfrogs offside, so we just snapped it real quick. Hayden Meyer stepped back, and Carter Riley just took off down the sideline, kind of lofted up. Carter Riley used his size to go up and just make a great catch right there. Got about 20 yards, so now we're first and 10 on our own 35.
That was a great over-the-shoulder pass.
That was a great, and it was a great job by Carter Riley using his big body to shield that defender off so the ball could come down in his hand.
Yeah, that's a big mismatch over there.
Yeah, exactly. So we're back in the flex zone. Leonard in motion. Oh, we got a pitch to Jaden. Uh-oh.
Oh, he missed tackle. Missed the block. Oh,
Jaden. Oh, I thought Jaden Rogers was going to get there.
He just got one pinky toe in foul territory.
I think they call that in football, they call that out of bounds. But, you know, that's all right. I understand you're a baseball coach. It's okay. But so now we got second nine. We got second one on that. That was a pickup of 9 yards. That was a great design play right there. Number 37 just barely slipped off that blocker. They would have been chasing Jaden for a while.
For a long time.
All right, so we got a second one here on the Bullfrog, on the Granbury 44-yard line. Oh, we're going to the other side. Oh, as we try to run the option, faked it up the middle, we're going to run that option again. It came on Hayden Meyer. He was going to flip it out there to Jeff Leonard, but he kind of slipped when he was making that cut.
That's probably the wise decision. Just keep that, take the loss, and let's get it on the next one. We're third and one.
We get it. We got about a third and three right here. I have confidence right here. Everybody in tight. We're just going to overload them. Oh, we just snapped it to Hayden Meyer, and we just got a rugby scrum going right here, and it's still going, folks.
What a good job by our offensive line there.
Yeah, dude, I mean, the offensive line just started doing it, and then everybody else just fall in right behind Hayden. Push that thing forward, and so now we're sitting on the Bullfrog 48-yard line. Dude.
Number 70, Enrique Sanchez, that was really a big push by him over there.
Yeah, and then you had big Monty Whipple right up the middle snapping it right there. He's got a big nose guard sitting right over the top of him. Right there, oh, we got a fumble on the snap right there. Pirates were able to get back on it. May have lost about a half yard. They're going to call it 1 yard loss. So we're going to have a second and 11 on this play.
That's kind of the one thing you don't want to do in this kind of offensive, have a slippery ball, right?
Exactly. You don't want that to happen. You know, this offense is kind of like Air Force, predicated on positive yardage every snap. You don't want to get behind the chains.
That's exactly right.
Uh-oh. We are going to get a flag on that, folks. We had Jeff Leonard and Jaden Rogers both go in motion at the same time. I don't know what happened. Had a little confusion right there. So
I don't think we can do that.
We had two men in motion at the same time. So that, yeah, no, you can't. That'll be it. I see the bullfrog. It looks like it was a loss of about 2.5 yards, maybe even 3, on the play. So the Bullfrogs have declined the penalty. So it'll be third down and about 15. We need one of those offsides again. Or we just flip it out to Carter Riley. Hey, what we need is positive yards here to give us a chance to make a decision on fourth down, what we're going to do. It's a pitch to Jaden Owen.
Another fumble. Looks like they recovered it.
Looks like we weren't comfortable. It looks like their officials are signaling bullfrog football. We're going to put so we need it.
They're going to get good field position again on this turnover here.
They're going to be in positive territory. They're going to be on the Granbury side of the field on the 44-yard line.
Make sure you have, ain't got nothing wrong with that.
As the Bullfrogs come out, just had a couple of kinks in the armor in the last couple of offensive possessions. They're going to get that worked out. They're talking on sideline. They're getting this all fixed. Going trips left again. Here they go. They're going to do a little swing. Here comes. They did a little swing pass out to number 3. And that is a whole ship of Pirates right there coming at you.
And that was a lot of running for very little yardage.
Well, they picked up about 5 yards. It looks like they got about a 5-yard gain on that. Kind of swung it out of the backyard. That's kind of a dangerous pass right there, because if you miss that pass, that's a backwards pass, and now it's a scrum for the football. We're going twins on this second down and 5. They're going to just hand it off to big number 3 right up the middle. It looks like he might have picked up about 2 yards. They'll bring it up about a third and three. They may have given him 3 there, doesn't it look like?
I think that was a fairly generous mark.
But you know, hey, that's not an exact science. You're trying to figure out where the momentum stopped. They're going to run that same play, run him up the middle again. And it looks like they got about 5 that time, so they're running. They're about the 31-yard line. Pirates, clock's ticking down. We're about 7:53. As soon as they spot this ball, that clock will get rolling. Still a 21-7 lead for your Pirates. They're gonna run that little sweep with that guy right with number 5. They like that.
That's Cornell Avington. He's the he's pretty good little optional weapon they have there.
Yeah, they bring him in motion and just hand him the ball right there, and he's a quick little kid. So
and Damian Hopkins, he's a pretty big boy, so they're letting him.
We're gonna step back. We're gonna try to throw again. Number 6 makes a man miss, but we got pressure on number 45 right
there. We got a face mask there.
Chase Cantrell did a great job of pursuing that, and then the guy cut back on him. I'm not sure if they call it on him or
whoever they called it on. We got a face mask for sure.
Yeah, it's not really going to matter what number they call it on. They're going to call it on. They're going to call a face mask. Oh, face mask is going to get 15 yards right there. So they're going to be down close to our 10-yard line when they finish it all. 13-yard line is what it's going to be.
And, you know, it seems like right now we're
scrambling a little bit.
We're scrambling and we're trying to beat ourselves a little bit here.
Here we go. Number 3 right there. He's going to try to slide out. He did a great job. Had him wrapped up initially. Then he got through that. Looks like he only picked up about a yard.
Chase Cantrell had him there for a little bit, and he just got a little free.
I think that was, wasn't that number 1, Augie Zapata, that had the initial contact? Actually, they're saying they gave about 2 or 3, so.
Wow.
They're going to run a quarterback lead right there. Number 98. Got a little penetration to set. I don't think so.
That's Jack Damphouse.
Jack Damphouse just grabbed him, swung him down. You know that they're probably going for – this is four-down territory for them based on what we've seen from them.
There's no evidence we're kicking the ball.
No, so they're on the 9-yard line. Pirates need to step up right here and limit any yardage right here and then force them to have a fourth and long. Got number 5 in motion. They're going to hand it to him. He had to bubble around right there. Great job. Who is that? That
was number 20. That's Austin Maine.
No, Austin Maine came up and made the tackle. Is that number 29 or 28?
We're too old to see that.
Maybe, yeah, it may have been Anthony DeBello out there did a great job. Or heck, it could have been number 20. Rylan Brennan stepped up right there and hit that outside blocker and held that up and forced number 5 to have to bounce around him. And that allowed the defense to rally the ball. So we got a 4th and 10, folks. There we go. We're going to step back. We're going to try to throw. There's pressure coming. Oh!
Austin Maine almost had a pick.
Yeah, Austin Maine almost had a pick, but you know what? At the angle he was going, he would have ran out of bounds right about that same spot. So
we're going to get the ball back.
We're going to get the ball back anyway. It was a great – hey, despite whether it was a pick or not, it was great coverage by the Pirates and great pressure by the boys up front. Chasing him, I think that was Damphouse chasing him down again, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
We have binoculars up here, folks. We're going to have to start using because as the night goes on, our eyes get worse.
And the lights aren't as bright as we think.
There we go. Right? A little toss sweep right there to Jaden. He gets out there, turns the corner, gets about 2 or 3 yards on the carry. Looks like they gave him two because we started on the 12, went to the 14. I can see the hash marks on the field. That's a good thing. I can still see that.
Yep. That's a positive, Jimmy.
I'm trying to go glass half full there.
Good. Danny.
All right, we're under center. Jeffrey Leonard in motion. A little toss sweep to Jeffrey.
Stumbled there.
Stumbled right there.
We may have gone backwards
yard.
There.
Yeah, I think we lost a yard on that play. So we're going to have about a 3rd and 9 right here. They got a little Full Metal Jacket playing on their scoreboard. I don't know if that's – is that scoreboard approved?
Wouldn't be at our house.
No, I mean, that's a – all right, so we're back in our bone. We got one
– 3rd and 8.
Got a 3rd and 8. Leonard in motion. We're going to roll out. We got a receiver slipped out. Is that Tyler Rogers slipped out
is.
Of the backfield? Right there.
Let's go.
He's
going
to the
house.
To the end zone.
Let's go.
Number 17.
Good cut back.
Oh, hey, nice job by Tyler. Hey, right
That's
there, Tyler
Rogers.
We did a little fake there and just kind of a boot out here to the left side. And Tyler Rogers slid right out of the backfield right there. Nobody was on him. Dumped it to him. He makes a great job. Outruns him down to now we're on the Bullfrog 26-yard line. If I was really –
And that's what this offense does for you. You pound it, you pound it, you pound it.
It's about a 55-yard run, our spotter says. I was going to wait on Mr. Guidry to tell me, but he's good with the words and not the numbers.
If you're waiting on me to do that,
right,
man.
We got a little stick. Jaden Rogers doing a great job with the stiff arm and just kept carrying number 37. Number 37 wasn't sure what it. He came up and he saw a number 27, and then the next thing you know, he saw a hand in his face mask with a stiff arm, and he didn't see anything after that until 9 yards down the field.
I tell you what, Jaden Rogers, he really runs tough, doesn't he? I mean, he's a tough player.
He's gonna force you to have a couple of bruises if you're gonna come up and tackle him. So we got a 2nd and 1 in motion again. It's gonna be Tyler Rogers. Hey, that was a great cut by Tyler Rogers. He saw that opening, kind of slid out the backside. Little quick cut in the hole, made a step, planted and cut out the backside, picked up a few extra yards.
Now we got a first down.
We got a first down on the Bullfrog 11. Hey, this is a great drive for the Pirates. Gives our defense a little time to rest. Gets a little momentum going back on our side here.
Well, especially with the
clock's
last
ticking.
Series of plays we did.
Yeah. There we go. Jaden Rogers, tall sweep right there. He's got a little bit of a hole. Oh, great play. And he dives from the pylon.
Yeah,
we got
good.
In there right there.
What a great run, my dude.
Who was that? That was number 77. That's old Parker Temple, number 77, getting out there, pulled around
and blocked for him.
Pulled around. That's Jaden Rogers' third touchdown of the night. Jaden made a little step. That defense froze just a second, and Parker Temple was out there to shield that guy, and Jaden just cut right off that and said, all right, it's just a race to the pylon, and here goes Weston. Nice little kick to the end zone.
Jimmy, I think even you with your bad knees could run behind Parker Temple. What do you think?
Well, I don't know about that. He did a great job of blocking, but you got to understand, I'm pretty slow. I don't have much burst.
You're right.
I usually pull a hamstring if I try to have too much of a quick burst, and so I'd probably just hit the ground.
That's probably true.
The sad thing is, the big boys would open up a hole for me, and I'd just be laying on the ground grabbing my hamstring.
I've been there.
Yes. Were we supposed to say that?
So somewhere down on the field, we have our pirate production crew. We got Don Bradley over there in our end zone.
Don Bradley's down there on the camera. Looks like she got old cowboy David Winkleman in his shorts and his cowboy hat with Victor Sanchez right there. All right, folks, here we go. We got to feel a little power coming from the people at the house here. On this kickoff, we're gonna have to teach our fans. Our adult fans weren't there when Coach Shahan got the hook, so we're gonna have to teach them. So here we go, Western Cantrell back. He's getting ready to boot this into the wind. Here we go.
Here we go.
Boom! Oh, that's a line drive kickoff. Okay. It looks like
hey, that's a good bounce.
But it went out of bounds. That was a great kick, driving it into that wind, but it hit on about the 10. It hit right about the numbers on the 10-yard line, and that sucker just turned left. Kind of looked like one of my drives. Takes off the tee, and it looks like it's going to be pretty good, and then all of a sudden it turns left, and next thing you know, I'm in snake country.
Well, the good news is mine turns left and right, so.
Oh, okay. So you're an equal opportunity shanker is
absolutely
what I'm hearing.
Absolutely right.
Okay, I got you. All right, so it's time for the Pirate defense. We got a 28-7 lead with 3:16 left in the first half. Here's the Pirate defense. Got a little bit of a breather to get their feet back under them, come back out. It looks like they got stack on both sides out wide. Here we go. We're gonna run it right up the middle. Okay. Who was somebody? Our defensive end right there. And that. Wish I could tell you the number, folks. I'm so sorry. We're doing these poor boys some injustice by not being able to see their numbers and give them shout outs like they deserve. I blame that on Coach Guidry. He didn't bring his CNI glasses tonight. Here we go. They're in that stack again. They're going to throw it out to number 5. They're going to try to do a quick hit. Got a guy blocking in front of him. He's just going to run out of bounds about the 43-yard line.
That's by Rylan Brennish.
Oh, it was Rylan Brennish. That's what our spotter up here. Got Cole Bradley. He ran over here and got the binoculars because he said, you guys need some help.
And he's super young.
I mean, he doesn't even really need the binoculars. No. He's supposed to have good eyes at that age. Here we go. We got a snap back. He's back to throw. He's stepping up. Feels a little pressure. He's just going to flip it out there. It's going to be out of bounds.
That was great coverage in our secondary. No, there was just no place for him to throw.
No, he kept stepping up, thinking he was going to have a little seam to run or something. Couldn't, and then he just lobbed that thing out of bounds. 33 with the pressure.
Sam Sutherland.
That's Sam Sutherland. All right, so number 6 back right there at quarterback.
That's Jose Meza.
There you go. We're going to step back. They're going to run a little wide receiver screen. Oh!
With a flicker.
They're going to do a little hook and ladder with that screen. They barely got the pitch off because
they were pretty lucky to get that done. That was Chase Cantrell there on the tackle.
Yeah, the tackle. They picked up about 5. They got about 5 on the play, maybe 4 or 5 on the play. So it's going to bring up a 3rd and 5. Got the crowd yelling, let's go defense, get them, and here we go. We're going to step back. We're going to throw it over the middle.
Oh.
Guy just settled down. Number 13 just settled down right there in the middle of the zone. Found a little window. Got it down.
It was Charles Williams Lawrence on the catch.
Yeah, to about the, it's about the Pirate 36-yard line. We're going trips right this time. Here we go. Stepping back. We're going to try to chunk it. We've got pressure. He's trying to throw. Oh, great. Number three,
Josh McGinnis almost had flying. That one. He almost had that ball.
He read that. He read the quarterback's eye, came flying, kind of made a Superman dive right there and almost picked that thing off.
Through the wickets.
Hey, but you know what it does? Brings up a second and 10 for the Bullfrogs with 2:07 left in the first half. Forcing them to have to make a play. They're going to go trips right again with a single back in the backfield. Stepping back. He's looking, they read, right there. They were going to try to run that screen again, but our defensive line read that. Number 33, Sam Sutherland just ran right there with the back and said, you know, there's not many times you see a D lineman in a position that he's about to pick one off and try to outrun everybody to the house, but he was...
He was there.
He was there. And so they just dumped that off, got it out. It's 3rd and 10 on the Pirate 36-yard line. Stepping back, number six, number three moving to the left side of number six, the quarterback. There we go. Here's a snap, gonna step back. Oh, it's gonna be a little quarterback draw. He's gonna try to run. Oh, he found a little lane.
Cameron James on the tackle there.
So he made... That was a first down for them. That was a 14-yard, about 13, 14-yard pickup right there. Get it down to the Pirates, 21. I thought at first we were going to have him in the backfield. They'll run number five in motion, setting up twins on both sides. He's going to step back. He's going to try to run that little screen there. There you go, Sam. Great job by Sam at the defensive end. That guy tried to, they're going to try to run that little wheel route again, get number five down the sideline. Our defense, our secondary set right on that. There wasn't anything open. And Sam just chased it. And then we're getting ready.
Seconds away from hearing our fantastic band. They're getting ready to have their second game of the year.
We'll have the Stowaway. I bet the Stowaway is going to go out on the field first. Stowaway is going to do another fine performance, and then our color guard and our band are going to set. Go there, so don't go. Oh, great play right there. That was number 20. That was Rylan Brennish right there. Hit the receiver right as the ball hit him. It looks like it's going to be timeout for the Bullfrogs. Yeah, our band, our color guard, and our Stowaways are going to put on a great halftime show, so please do not walk away from your set. At that point, I think Mr. Guidry and I are going to probably go try to find the hospitality room. We may try to mix in a brownie, although somebody said a little something off about the brownies. I don't know about that, but you know.
I don't know about all that.
I'm instead of taking their word for it, I'm going to try it myself because, you know.
You do that.
I've worked hard on this gut. I don't want to just give it away for free. All right, so we're gonna have a live interview, or you can go on to our Instagram account and you can check out some of the interviews that our Pirate Production Studios have done. They do a fine job interviewing people. I've never been interviewed by them. Have you, Mr. Guidry?
Just in school. We've only been interviewed a few times in school about various things.
They don't really give us. It's amazing they gave us this much mic time tonight. All right, so we're back live here. There we go, number six. He's rolling right. He's looking at number 13. Oh, pass was just a little bit wide on that. Just a little bit wide. So that's going to bring down a 4th down and 10. And so we got 1:21 left.
Down 21 points. 4th and 10. We have an opportunity to get a little points on the board, but we're going to try to go for it anyway.
Well, you know, hey, they've shown that they like to go for it. They haven't shown a punting game, and I don't know what the range on their field goal kicker is. So they're going to take their chance with their offense on the field. They're going to step back, running number seven across. They got a man just overthrew.
Overthrew.
That was great coverage by number 12 out there. Number 12, Christian Paddock, was running stride for him, forced him to have to throw it a little bit high. So now we got 1:17 left in the
we got a minute 17. We have two timeouts. We got a chance to take the ball down the field if we want to.
We do. Number 78, that's big Monty Whipple right there, man. He was dancing out there. He's ready. He wants the power. He's ready to go. He wants to run over that nose guard right there. He's like, just follow me. Follow the purple pants of number 78 is what he said.
That's what he said.
There we go, Hayden under center. There goes Jeffrey Leonard. They're going to come back to the right. We got a pitch to Jaden. He's got the corner, and that could be six. Oh, number, I got an angle on him. He's sitting there. He's reading it. Boom, right there. That was a nice job. Jeffrey Leonard got out there, was shielding that, shielding number 17. But, hey, when they sucked that in, when they pitched that right there to Jaden, Jaden turned that corner and he didn't see anything but bullfrog grass. He didn't see the bullfrog defenders till he was about 20, 30 yards downfield. So we got 105, and we're all the way down to the bullfrog 28-yard line, folks. Did you say 50 or 60
yards? 60 yards.
60-yard run. That was a good run right there. Oh, we're going to go back to that.
Oh, they saw that one coming this time.
They saw that. We tried to go to the short side of the field. When we went to the short side of the field, they kind of closed that. They trying to close that short side of the field. Looks like the Pirates are going to take a timeout with 53 seconds left. It's going to be about a second and 11 when they come out of this timeout. I believe at this point, we're trying to draw up something. Why don't you tell your cousin to call the scoring play?
Well, I told him that before the game this morning when I saw him in the cafeteria. I said, hey, let me tell you like every parent, every football parent ever, run the scoring plays. If you don't know what those are, we got a problem. Hey, speaking of pirate parents, our crowd, I would say, rivals that of Lake Worth, if not more. We have a packed house for the Pirates tonight, which I'm so glad to see the community come out and support our Pirates tonight.
Hey, you know, I think that we ought to switch sides with the Lake Worth Bullfrogs because I think we need the bigger stands and they need the smaller stands. Our Pirate family came out and supporting them. Here we go. We're on back live here. We got them in motion. Oh, Tyler Rogers slipped a tackle right at the line of scrimmage. He's still churning right there. That was a great cut. Oh, he's still going, man.
That was some gutsy running right there.
Right there, right at the line of scrimmage, he saw the cut. He started to make the cut, and that guy tried to get him. He slid right underneath that guy. The guy went right over top, tried to grab hold of him. He went, and he buried it, ducked his shoulder, and got a first down for the Pirates. First and 10 on the Bullfrog 18-yard line. Here we go. We're coming back. There's the pitch to Jaden Rogers. He can beat that guy.
Oh, we got him sucked in again.
All right, there. We got one man to beat, and he's there. That's going to be touchdown number 4 for Jaden tonight. You know, last week it was the Tyler Rogers show, and this week they're keying on Tyler Rogers, and it's the Jaden Rogers show. I mean, this offense just, hey, whatever you do, it's wrong.
That's right. Well, if you're not really disciplined on defense, Coach Otten's offense is tough to defend if you're not disciplined.
Here we go. Weston Cantrell on the point after, and he is good again. So it's going to be 35-7 with 31 seconds left. But you are right. I mean, and whatever you do, it's wrong. And the other thing that's great about this offense is everybody's gone to the spread these days.
Yes.
And so now all of a sudden, all these teams are used to preparing for the spread. They're used to preparing for all that spread. Then all of a sudden, here you come with the flex bone, and you don't know who's getting the ball. And you got to play sound, tough defense. And then if you make one mistake, one guy doesn't read the play right, guess what? You right there, yep. Jaden Rogers making burn. Last week, Tyler Rogers took it right up the middle. That was about a 70-yarder, 75-yarder.
Last week it was 70, yeah.
Yeah, and stuff right up the rudder. So, I mean, it's right there, you know. So, you know, Jeff Leonard's had some carries and stuff, and his time's going to come where it's going to be his show because they're going to key on the other two. So,
yeah, and that's really the tough thing. And you hadn't really got we don't really have Justin Leonard involved yet, but that could happen at any moment.
All right, so we're going to get another kickoff with 31 seconds. All right, the cheerleaders down here supporting their Pirates are just, Hey, their arms are going to get tired throwing footballs and T-shirts up into the stands because they're fighting the wind when they throw it up in there. They're doing a fine job getting it to the crowd.
I think Coach Epper ought to look into recruiting some of these.
Well, you know, hey, you never can have enough pitching, can you?
Nope.
All right, here we go, folks, from home. Let's hear you.
Oh, boom. Oh,
there you go. We're just going to kick it. Oh, takes a nice hop over.
That's a great
pass. Feel it staying. There we go. We stayed it. Looks like they had a little bit of a crease. State 42 on the tackle, which is Brian Steven. Brian Steven made a nice tackle right there. They had a little bit of crease, but then the Pirates rallied to the ball. Hey, you know what I forgot? And guess what? I can see some things.
Well, that's a miracle.
I mean, I actually can see the numbers better now.
That's good.
Hey, I paid for these things. I ought to wear them.
That'd be handy.
All right, we're going to see what the Bullfrog. The Bullfrog's just going to try to run it out the half, going to the half 35-7. No, they're going to step back. They're going to try to throw it. He tries to throw it deep. He has number five again had a step on us, and the ball just kind of drifted right over his head, and he just
number five, that's Cornell Abington. He is the slipperiest frog of them all over there, I think.
He is. We had a little pressure up front, making him get rid of it. 18 seconds left. You know, big thing is just keep everything in front of you and rally to the ball. Yeah, they're going to step back. They're going to try to run a screen to number five. Once again, he's trying to cut back across the middle of the field.
And he got a first down.
He got a first down on it. He got about 12 yards. He's going to be at the Granbury 48. And the Bullfrogs are going to take a timeout with 10 seconds left. And so we had Cameron James on the tackle. Yeah. Yeah, and right, you know, at the end of the half, especially with only 10 seconds left, Granbury was playing off a little bit, to keep everything in front of us, not allow the big play, not allow something to happen to change momentum.
Yeah, the last thing you want to do in a situation like this is give up silly points at the end of a half.
Yeah, so I think that's what Coach Barnes is saying right there in the Pirate huddle. Yeah. Coach Barnes taking over as defensive coordinator this year.
And those are some big shoes to fill out of Coach Galindo. But
yeah.
We have him as our fearless leader now, but Coach Galindo always did a great job on defense as well.
He did. He always had them. So now here we are. We're back out. We got twins again. Single back, number six. Here we go. We're going to step back right now. They're going to a little pump. All right there. 4 second play. They made a little out cut right there. Got it down to the Pirate 35. I don't know if they're not just weren't just trying to get some well, who's called timeout? The Frogs just used their last timeout right there, even though the play was out of bounds and the clock was stopped there. I don't know if they weren't just trying to get some yardage so that then they could throw a Hail Mary down there into the end zone. I'm sure they're going to try to run some little misdirection, try to get one of those swing routes open. I have a feeling that our Pirates are going to probably play, we're going to play deep coverage and just try to keep it everything and rally again.
Yeah,
we're not going to try to fall for anything, or I mean, so what if they get 20 yards on the play? It's going to run out of clock and going at halftime, they're still down 35-7. Not the Pirates, the Frogs would be.
Yeah, I think we're going to play really deep here. We're not going to let anything get behind us.
Okay. All right. So here we go. We're set up, playing a little off coverage. We're all right. They got trips, right? They got two receivers to the left. They're going to step back. Here we go. They're going to just chunk it deep, but we got two Pirates there.
Oh.
And
we had it intercepted.
We intercepted number 12, Christian Paddock, I believe, on that. Was sitting right there. He intercepted it with 0 seconds left in the end zone. That goes down on a stat pattern.
That sure does.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stay with us. Stay on the broadcast and support our stowaways, our color guard, and our Pride of Granbury band.
spot right here.
Yeah, I zoomed in. Yeah, I wish they faced us, since they're our band.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, welcome back to, got about a minute 30 left. We'll run down some things real quick. We were told that right now, you know, they wanted to run up 600 yards of offense tonight, Mr. Guidry, and it looks like we're at 291. So we're just not quite halfway there, but, you know, hey, gonna roll through that. But before we get to that, you know, another outstanding performance by the Stowaways, the Top Guard, and the Pride of Granbury Marching Band. They did a fine job at halftime once again.
And, you know, the I'll say this again, I say this all the time, that I think the band is some of the hardest working kids in our entire school. They're up to the school early, they stay late, they really work hard and do a fantastic job.
Yeah, you know, all of these organizations, all of these things that our students are part of, man, they really put in a lot of work. You know, it doesn't matter what, you know, which one you're talking about or whatever. You know, you look at our cheerleaders running out right there with the football team, the Stowaways, the color guard band, you know, and, you know, don't mention the football team. I mean, right. Heck, you know, it's been a little hot in those pads, but, you know, I think all of them do a great job. And they put in a lot of hard work to represent our school in a very positive way.
Yeah, you know, you only see it here on Friday nights or whenever they perform, but nobody sees what they do in the dark, and that's really to be commended. Like you said, for everybody, cheerleaders, Stowaways, football players. I know football practice has not been very, very fun in the heat, but hopefully cooler days are ahead, right?
We hope so. We're supposed to be at 100 tomorrow for the kickoff of the college football season, but, you know, hey, let's get ready for the second half here with your Granbury Pirates leading 35-7. You know, had just a couple of little hiccups, or that score might have been 49-7.
Yeah, we had some bad things go against us for a couple possessions there, but I think we settled in, and I think we're going to be just fine the second half.
Exactly. So once again, we got Halston Main and Jaden Rogers deep. It looks like number 24. Mr. Carranza, senior kicker for the Bullfrogs.
I want to be honest with you here, Jimmy. This is it's a little dark up here right now.
There we go. Kick's underway. It looks like it's going to be a line drive kick. It looks like it's going to take a hop out of bounds right about the 8-yard line. So there comes the flag in from the official. So the Granbury's going to start with pretty good field position this time again. It feels as if the wind may have picked up just a hair.
Yeah, now we're going to go against the wind this half, and we'll see what that really doesn't weigh too heavy on us since it's a ground and pound.
Yeah, ground and pound there. Well, it looks like instead of electing to take the ball with an extra 5 yards on that, we're going to go ahead and make them have to kick it again.
Hey, I like it.
Hey, you know what? Coach Galindo's thinking here, let's see, hey, we got to work on our kickoff for turn two. Let's see if we can't make something exciting happen right off the bat. Yeah. All right, we got Austin Main and Jaden Rogers back deep again. We got number 24, Carranza, left-handed kicker, or left-handed, man. I guess that's a left-footed, isn't it?
Yeah, again. It's not baseball, Jimmy.
I know. It's not baseball, and, you know, I'm not so good with the words. I'm better with the numbers, but, you know, we'll do our best here. There we go. Put a foot into it. Just punches one. He punches it short. Kind of dies. Halston picks it up. Scoots up the right side, and then kind of comes back to the middle. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. We got a little extra skirmish down here on our side of the field. Yeah, I think that might be a flag on both of us. We're not going to.
I don't know. Hayden Burke. And so we got it up to about the 38.5-yard line on the kickoff return. The officials are huddled together. You know what? You think they're talking about what would make not a nice wedding gift?
Well, candlesticks probably always make a nice gift, and always see where they're registered.
You get a nice play setting on that too. All right, here we go. Referee's going to come back. He's going to give a little. Coach Galindo is anxious to see what that kind.
to see what that call is.
Make sure that you stay on
referee's sitting there explaining it to Coach Galindo.
So if you don't get something,
and it
you don't
looks,
get
it appears as it may be going against the Bullfrogs.
2 minutes left. Let's go ahead and have Blutes go, Clarinets go first. If you're not in that section, I'm not going to let you go.
All right. So the referee's going to go explain it to the other coach. I don't even know what
we don't even know what the call is yet, do we?
We do not, but they're marking off 15 yards against the Bullfrogs, so we're going to start. Oh.
So whatever it is, we like it.
Hey, I'm going to say that we're going to start off on the Bullfrogs' 46 and a half yard line right there.
Brass, trumpets, and horns, go ahead and join them.
All righty, so let's get this party started. We're going to come out in a familiar formation. Looks like we're going to put both our receivers to the left side, and I bet we're in the flex bone look in the backfield. What do you bet there, Coach Kidrick?
Yeah, I think that's been the recipe.
Yeah, here we go. Now we're going to got Jaden Rogers in motion. Oh, we're going to toss. We're going to overload them at the point of attack. Tyler Rogers was able to turn the corner, but they had a little bit of an angle on him. But he picked up, it looks like he picked up about 4 yards on the play. So
I think
second six.
I think Lake Worth is getting a little bit frustrated. They're getting there's a little bit of extra stuff going on after the play there.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like they're kind of like on that kickoff. You know, the guy grabbed Hayden Burns by the face mask and drug him down and threw him around and stuff like that, trying to. And on that one, they got a little chippy. There's Jaden in motion again, but we're gonna hand it to Tyler right up the middle. He slid out the back side, back to the right. Picked up about three or four yards right there.
We should be just a couple yards short of the first down here.
Yeah, we're going third and two.
You know, you got to really, this is Hayden Meyer's first year as a starting quarterback, and you really got to take your hat off to him for learning a new system like this and being disciplined enough to be a team player to understand he's not going to throw the ball 40, 50 times a game.
Yep. Uh-oh. There we go. We got it. Oh, Hayden Meyer's around the corner. He's running. And he's got a free. If he can out one man to beat, guy just cut him down right there. That's going to be a big run down to about the 8-yard line, it appears.
And when you can do that, why run the football? Why throw the football?
He's struggling with the words tonight. I mean, may be past bedtime.
It is. It's getting close.
Yeah.
I mean, it's been a long day, sir.
Did you take your Geritol today?
I did.
Okay, all right. So we're good to go. All right, so now Pirates have a first and 10 at the 8-yard line. Still two receivers left in the flex bone look. That time was Jeffrey Rodden. Now we're going to do a pitch. Uh-oh, Jaden got through. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, we got a
ball.
Ball
came loose. It's a scoop. All right, well.
And that's what we can't do.
Jaden Rogers kind of slipped through there, and that guy happened to get his helmet right on the ball and it popped free. And the Bullfrogs were right there, scooped it up, and ran it out to about the 30-yard line. So we're gonna go on defense.
Yeah, you know, that's just that's bad luck on our part. That's one of the things you can't do in this kind of offense is you cannot be undisciplined with the ball. You gotta keep the ball. That's sort of the point.
Yeah, you know, that's not a normal thing for Jaden. That was a little unlucky for him. That guy happened to get a hand or a helmet right on the ball. Now they're going to try to just run that quarter. There's your slippery little frog again, number five right
yep.
there. Just took that snap and just went straight.
Direct snap for Cornell Abington.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see them try to feature him pretty much this whole second half, see if he can't. They got about 7 yards on that carry, so it's going to be second and three. Trips left. Here we go. We're going to hand it off to the big fullback right up the middle. Whoa, wow. Who Whoa. Was that? That was number 25. Can you turn your flashlight on because it's dark up here?
That's Anthony, 29, Hayden Burns.
Are you sure? I thought that was 25, Anthony DiBello, but it doesn't matter. He came, got shot out of cannon, put him in. Stopped his momentum, so we're at a third and three. They're going to step back, try to throw a quick pass here. Quarterback and the receiver were not on the same page there.
He threw right, running went left.
That's not a good combination when that happens.
No, sir.
No. It looks like we have a bullfrog down on the play. Appears to be one of their offensive linemen. They seem to be working on his left leg there, ankle or knee there. Never want to see that.
No, that's not good. We don't want anybody hurt out here. So far, in regards to that, it's been a pretty clean game, and we want to keep it like that.
Yeah. Hopefully, he looks like he's going to hop. I thought he was going to hop right up right there. They're going to get him up on his feet for pretty quickly. There we go.
That's good to see.
Yeah, he's up on his feet. It looks like he's walking off under his own power. Little hitch in the giddy up, but you know, he's walking off on his own.
That's number 51, Michael Andrade.
Who was that?
Michael Andrade, number 51 there for Lake Worth Bullfrogs.
Yeah, we wish him the best. Oh, he's... All right. Well, with that, it's going to bring up a 4th and 3. We have yet to see the Bulldogs punt team on the field. Well, we saw them on the field in their first possession, but they faked the punt.
They faked it.
And we're not successful, so we'll see what they try to do here.
Yeah, there's no evidence that they're going to kick this football.
Well, it looks like their quarterback, number 6, is their punter also. He's in the punt formation. It looks like they're missing a left guard on their punt team. They're trying to slide them down. So we'll see if they're going to fake this.
We got them. They got us offsides.
Well, we moved, but I don't know.
Maybe they moved. Oh, they moved first. That's good.
Well, we moved, and then one of their guys moved. They seem to be looking at us like they're going to call it on us. They are going to call offsides on the Granbury Pirates right there.
That'll be a first down.
It's a tough break right there.
So we still don't know if they have a punt team or not.
It looks like they were missing a guy on their punt team even when they went out there. It looked like they only had 10 men on the field. So, it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Bullfrogs on their own 43-yard line after the offsides call.
That is unfortunate. We had a chance to get off the field there potentially and get our offense out there to eat up some more clock, and we're just going to have to make a stop here.
So we're in the twins. They're in the twins formation again. Number 6, the quarterback. Here comes number 5 in motion. You can bet he's probably – they fake it to him. And then they're going to try to throw a little pass to him.
Oh, no.
Number 20 right there, Ryland Brennish, was on the coverage. He saw him coming out of the backfield. He stepped up. He hit number 5, and then number 5 kind of slid around the edge, and he kept running with him, made it a difficult pass.
You know, and probably it's a great thing that he did, because that kind of disrupted the entire play.
It did. All right, so here we are. We're in the same setup with our twins formation. They're just going to step right back. They're going to throw it. Oh, wow. Number 29 makes initial contact. He's running backwards.
Weird.
This is going to be, looks like number 25 on the tackle there. To stop him, that was Anthony DiBello. Who did I say was the first one to hit him? 29, that was Hayden Burns, correct? Hayden Burns read that little screen off the that little swing pass off of it, and he came like a shot, and he hit him, and the guy tried to reverse his field, kept running backwards.
What we had to have. We had to have a loss. We had to try to get field position back here.
And that's going to put them in a 3rd and 23, a loss of about 13 yards. They're going to step back. We can set on it. Over the middle. Austin Main on the coverage, number 7, trying to come across the middle. Their pass was a little high, but Austin Main, even if he'd have caught it, Austin Main was going to drop him right there on the spot, and it wasn't even going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. So now we may get a chance to see that punt, see if they can punt.
We might yet, sir, see if we're gonna what we're gonna do here.
Yeah, when our offense gets back on, it may be sponsored by Subway because we need to eat a little clock.
That's for sure.
All right.
Subway sandwich would actually be pretty good right now.
Number six with the punt. Right there, hauls the main underneath it. Makes one man miss and gains about 5 yards on the return. So the Pirates will start on their own 40-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 Pirates on the 40. You know, last week, Austin did a lot of fair catching. This week, he's like, I want a chance to return one.
Yeah, well, that low kick going with the wind, he got the ball a lot sooner this time and had that opportunity.
All right, so here we go. Now we're going to flex ball. We're going to receive a split both sides here.
This is a little different look for us here.
We used this a few times tonight. Here we go. Is it littered in motion? He comes back.
There we go.
Oh, we got the pitch. Oh, man.
Oh,
it was a great job by Jaden Rogers. He got caught in the backfield for about a 2 yard loss.
Oh, hey, we got a, let's say, whoa.
We got, but that initial hit happened about 2 yards deep in the backfield, had him around the legs, and Jaden kept spinning and, wiggled himself free.
You know, I tell you what, that looked like a little bit of a late altercation there in the.
Yeah, 15-yard run by Jaden right there for a first down for the Pirates. We're now on the Bullfrog 45-yard line. Yeah, it looks like he kind of ran him out of bounds and then wanted to kind of toss him again after that. But you know, no flag came out. We are playing up their field. That was a shout out to Euchert. All right.
But we got a flag here.
Oh, it looks like I thought they handed off the ball to Tyler Rogers. The next thing you know, there goes Hayden Myers running up the middle. But we got a flag, so before we call that 11-yard run, we're gonna see what the flag is. Oh, they're bringing it back. So are they gonna
against the Pirates here?
They're gonna call us for another illegal formation.
Could it be that these refs haven't ever seen this offense in a long time?
Well, you know, I think what it is they're not feeling that our offensive linemen are getting far enough up on the line of scrimmage, which, you know, all they got to do is break the plane with their helmet of the center's waist. And I think that they're doing that, but it's, you know, it's close at times. Right there, so see, look like we're right there. We're in the flex bone split wide, both seems wide. Jaden's in motion this time. We're going to step back. Oh, my goodness, number 17.
Oh, wide open. Wide open.
He's going to trot in there, number six. That was Hunter Burns, ladies and gentlemen. He was split out to the left, and all we did was step back and just nobody covered him. They sucked up on the run. I mean,
That's easy to do when you're primarily a run offense.
Yeah. Coach Guidry, even us being in the press box, I think we were closer to him than any Bullfrog defender.
That is a fact. We were, sir.
Yeah. All right.
We've got Cantrell back to kick an extra point here.
All right. So had a little trouble getting our team getting set on the field, but we're there now. Snap back. Cantrell's going to go up. He's going to punch it through. He's making that look easy.
Yeah, that's the snaps have not been the best, and he's still the holder and Cantrell have done a great job.
Yes, they have.
So we're 42-7. 7:45 left to go.
Hey, you know, I'm glad we got a lot of cheerleaders and they do a great job because their legs are going to get tired of doing flips tonight.
Yeah, they have done their fair share already.
Yeah, they're gonna need an ice bath later tonight or tomorrow, get that soreness out of their legs because they're doing a lot of running, a lot of flipping, and a lot of cheering.
Well, now the cheerleaders are down there on the track visiting the other cheerleaders. It almost looks like some sort of rumble that's going to take place, but I think they're it's all friendly.
I think that's just a presentation of each one. They just meet and they talk. But you know, I like your idea of it looks like a rumble. They gave it a different spin on it.
Yeah.
You obviously have not been in the cheerleading world ever.
No. Well, actually, that's not true. My wife is a cheerleader, a national champion cheerleader, by the way.
And she asked you not to say anything stupid tonight, and you just did.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, April. You can beg him and you can plead with him, but it just happens. Yeah. All right, we're gonna kick off again. So, they're doing a double
restorative circle time.
Yeah, exactly. They're doing a little circle time. Here we go. We're gonna get our pirate. Here we go. He's set. Here we go. You ready,
here
Coach?
We go. We're ready. We're ready.
Boom! All right, a little punch kick into the wind. That's gonna drop and hit the ground. They're gonna be late picking that up. We got some guys down there. He's bouncing around. He don't know which way to go. Slipped through a couple of guys, but we. Looks like Halston grabbed him by the shirt tail. And then...
Halston Main tried to get that ball, tried to punch that ball out, but he just missed it.
Yeah, it looks like Halston got him by the shirt tail, and it looks like Cameron James finished him off. They were punching at the ball. All righty. So the Pirate defense back out on the field. They've only given up 7 points tonight, and they've done a pretty good job of bowing their neck and making things happen when they needed to. That's going to be first and 10 Bullfrogs from their own 30-yard line. They're going to hand it straight up the middle to their running back, number three.
That is Damian Hopkins. He's also their quarterback when in certain plays, but I think he does a lot of direct snap stuff.
Yeah, he busted through for about 15 yards. They're going tempo right here, get another snap off. They're going to hand it right back to him. Number 90 gets an initial, that was Joshua Roth.
No, that
hit
was
him and slowed him down.
That
and
was Augie Zapata.
And then Augie Zapata clipped his legs out from underneath him. They're going to try to go tempo again. I guess when you're down 42-7, you need every second on the clock.
Yeah, because they know when we're on offense, they don't get a lot of time.
Yeah, so here we go. We're shifting right there. They're going to try to run a little counter. Oh,
got
nice
him.
Job
Augie
by
Zapata.
They were going to try to run a little bit of a counter there, but Augie came off of the end, and he beat the guard that was pulling from the right side to the left. He beat him to the point of attack.
And
got around him and made
a
nice play.
Tackle, but sometimes that's all you need.
Yeah, I mean, hey, his knee hit the ground, so we're on third and 9. We got a third and 9 right here from the Bullfrogs' 47-yard line. Got a trips right. Oh, man, they empty backfield. Got two right. They're going to try to run out there. Oh, that was a nice little play design. Looks like they're going to mark him right close to the first down. They're going to give him the first down. It's going to be first and 10.
My slippery frog, Arrington,
he's down on the ground.
Abington, he is down on the ground. That is not good for Lake Worth.
No, it looks like he's holding his knee.
Yeah.
And now, that's a bad sign.
That's not good.
I hate to see that for a kid. That was a little nice play design. They faked that little swing pass right there and then just slid right there into the middle. Found a little hole in the zone as we were going towards the swing pass. That is not, the Lake Worth Bullfrogs have not been effective throwing the ball very often, but every now and then they find that lightning.
Well, it's good to see him. There he is. Good.
He's jogging off. He wants to go back. He wants to go right back out on the offense, but he's got to set out a play. All righty.
Mr. Heffernan, you know what we failed to mention was our teacher of the week for the stowaways.
Oh, that's right. That was Miss Daffin, wasn't it?
It was.
Yeah. Miss Daffin can make a mean pan of brownies, too. She won't tell you what she puts in them. A little dab of this, a little dash of that.
Let me tell you how good they are, though.
A little teaspoon of that. But, yeah, she does a pretty good job with that. We got a boot out to the left side. He's going to try to throw it to the second level.
Just a little short.
That's a tough roll and throw when you're rolling to your left and trying to throw with your right hand. He just didn't get his shoulder squared around. That was a little bit short. Okay. So, you know.
So you got second and 10.
They got a second and 10 right there on their own, on our 44-yard line. They got that stack formation on both sides again out wide. They're just going to step and they're going to try to make a throw.
Oh, it's just overthrown.
They overthrew it, but number 12 out there, that's old Christian Paddock again. He was getting around that block and he was going to hit, He was probably going to hit number five right in the back if he hadn't overthrown that thing.
I think not catching that ball was in his best interest.
Yes. Now they went back to their twins look here with the single back in the backfield. They're going to step back. They're going to try to throw again right over the middle. Oh, it was number seven had it in his hands, but as he got it in his hands.
Josh McGinnis just put a hit on him and he dropped it.
McGinnis came up and lowered a shoulder right there, right in his chest right there, and came right across, knocked that ball right out.
So we got a fourth down here.
A fourth and 10.
I don't think they have a choice. I think they got to start going.
Well.
Which is what they've done all night.
I mean, is it any different? So we're going to step back. They're going to try to run across, and he sees him over the middle.
Oof.
Oh.
He heard footsteps.
He did hear footsteps. Taj Clayton was coming, and I think Taj Clayton was going to lower the boom on him, but I'm not so sure that Taj Clayton, if he had not seen the ball in the air, he might not have picked that thing off.
Yeah, I think looking tomorrow morning on tape, I think he'll wish that he was paying attention to the ball a little bit more.
Yeah, you know, but if your slippery little frog would have touched that ball, there would have been a hit because Taj was coming hard. Hey, so now here we go. We're back on offense. We got both receivers wide. We got wide left and wide right. Now here we go. Same setup in the backfield. There goes Leonard in motion. We're going to run the option that way. Hayden Myers is going to keep the ball and keep the legs churning, and he's going to pick up about 6 yards. No, it looks like they're going to give him about 6 yards on the play. That's a great run. Hey, but Coach Guidry, let's talk a little bit about hydration.
Yeah, you know, we got our student trainers down there, and they are doing a fantastic job because on a night like this, it's a little still heated. But they do a great job down there just keeping our players hydrated, keep them stretched out, give them what they need. They work hard down there. They're unsung heroes in the football team for sure.
Yeah, you don't ever realize how much they do because, you know, every time teams out working out, guess what? They're out there working. Oh, we got a little pitch out here. We ran the option. Oh. Jaden got around, and that, oh.
We're gonna get a crackback block. Yeah, we got a flag. That's coming back.
There's the flag. It looks like we got a block in the back. Looks like Coach Galindo's talking to one of our offensive linemen about getting out there. You know, it was just a hustle play, and he just got.
And Temple's done a great job all night, leading for Jalen over there, pulling and going, and so, you know. Things like that are going to happen. He'll be all right.
Yeah, he, you know, just. Hey, he was just hustling downfield trying to make a block and trying to make something happen for the team. Made a.
And unfortunately, just too good.
Yeah, let's see. And then we had another flag. This official. All right.
Offsetting penalties.
We got offsetting penalties on the play because further on down the field, you saw the official throw his hat. And when the official threw his hat, that was because they hit Jeffrey Leonard, kind of came back and hit him in an unnecessary manner. So we're going to do it again. We're going to be second and four. We got a mad bullfrog coach over there. He's not happy about the call.
Well,
but
this is too bad.
He's going to have to live with it because we're ready to snap the ball again. Oh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. They jump.
Well, our fans
they
are
jumped
not happy
offsides.
About that one.
The only thing that may have saved the bullfrogs on that was that they got far enough across that they called it a dead. Oh. They're calling it. They called procedure on us. Well, you know, let's go back above. We're going to be second and nine now.
Yeah. We're not going in the right direction.
Now, the last couple of plays have been a little sloppy, but now here it's time to buckle up. We're going to go second and nine right here from our own 45-yard line. Some of our fans down there are not happy about the call. They thought it should have been offsides instead of procedure. But, you know, you can yell about it all you want, but – They're not changing the call.
And they don't get a say.
No. We did a straight handoff right up the middle. Looks like it went for a no gain, so it's going to be 3rd and 9.
Yeah, I think they saw that play coming the entire time, and I think we'll look to try to draw them in again here. Maybe go. I think Coach Hawk can draw up one of those scoring plays we talk about all the time.
You know, it doesn't even have to be a scoring play. How about a 9-yard play, about a 9 or 10 yard play, keep the chains moving. I mean, that clock's rolling. It's 4:05 left in the third quarter.
And that's what we need, is the clock to keep rolling.
Yeah. There we go. We're coming out this way. A little pitch, a little option pitch. Jaden's got a hole. And Jaden's going down the sideline again.
Oh,
touch it back.
Bounds.
Oh, he stepped out of bounds,
bounds,
right about 30. The 30-yard line. Hey, that's all right. That's a first down, ladies and gentlemen. We've got some shenanigans going on right now, but we're all right. Here we go. We're going to do a – oh, they handed it to Tyler Rogers right up the middle.
And he's took through.
And that's going to be his second touchdown tonight. That's going to be a 30-yard gain right there. He did a little – oh, we got a little extracurricular. It looks like we're going to have a flag on the play. I don't know what
– hopefully that's after the touchdown.
We got an injured player on the field. Another Lake Worth bullfrog on the ground.
It looks as though that flag is going to be on us, Jimmy.
The official is walking over. They're talking. So
I don't understand what this call is.
Well, I can explain it to you all night. But I can't understand it for you there, sir. It looks like it's unsportsmanlike conduct after the play is what that. So what that means is we scored.
That's right.
And then we did something that they didn't think was sportsmanlike. Would you like me to explain it again?
No, or, that I can understand, sir.
Okay, all right. I'm just trying to get
Thank
with
you. Thank you for that.
Okay. So it appears that they're going to go ahead and put the touchdown on the board, and then we'll go there.
Will they assess that penalty on the extra point or on the kickoff?
I think that's a bullfrog decision.
I think it is too.
So we're he's still down. He's still I didn't get a number of him.
No, he's hurting though, and I hate that to see that, especially in a game like this.
Yeah, the game's starting to get out of hand. It doesn't take a mental giant to see that this game is getting out of hand.
That's for sure.
But you don't want to see anybody get hurt.
No, not in a game like this. When we got district coming up, starting next week. Speaking of next week, Mr. Heffernan, next week is homecoming for us.
It is homecoming. It's a short week. So we have the parade on what, Wednesday night?
Yes.
Oh, so lots of candy, lots of fun going down Pearl Street that night.
And that's a great time. I love the community coming out and being a part of that. It's such a great turnout. Now, what we don't know is we don't know about any fireworks because of the fire ban or the fire banning that's going on in the state of Texas. So it may be a little dry for fireworks. Nobody knows yet. It's that's just to be determined. That's above our pay grade. You know, whatever it is, it's going to be a great time. We'll have a great spirit night at the stadium. We look forward to everybody coming out next Friday night and supporting our Pirates for homecoming weekend.
Yeah, it'll be a, you know, even if we don't have fireworks, we're still going to have the spirit rally for the community on Wednesday night. And then on Friday morning, you know, we'll have a pep rally for the students at GHS. And then, you know, that night we'll have Friday night, have the homecoming game against the Waco High Lions. And then on Saturday night, I guess we got a homecoming dance. You know, I got asked one time if I was going to go to the dance, and I said I might be there, and they asked me if I was going to dance, and I said, well, there's no reason for me to break my hip. Listen, and somebody else's.
And I'm going to tell you right now, no one needs to see you do any dancing at all. I mean, you're already not very good looking, but then to add to that, dancing? No one needs to see this.
It's probably not, it's not a good look, no. Alright, so now it's good to see. It looks like it was number 26, McTobia Pilot Jr., and he is up.
He's hurting.
He is hurting, and they seem to be taking him towards our sideline. I don't know. I don't see any medical personnel over this way that could help him. Unless they're going to bring a cart around to get him, that's not a good look.
No, that is not. I hope the best for him.
I do.
We got a cart coming around now.
Oh, that, okay. I see the little John Deere carts coming around to get him on the track. The cheerleaders better move out the way. Our circle time is going to end in a nasty crash. All right. Cheerleaders moved on.
They're still down there rumbling, so we don't know what's going on there.
Yeah. Okay. All right, yeah, the cart got him. Okay, so we're still holding up. Let's get that kid on. The official's holding the play. He's like, hey, let's make sure we get that young man on the cart and get him taken care of before we. We're gonna kick it. So there we go. Snap is into the chest of the holder.
So that's good. So it looks like Lake Worth is gonna assess that penalty on the kickoff.
But, you know, hey, you know, we didn't even talk about the run by Tyler Rogers. We just handed it to him right up the middle. He made a little head fake like he was going to go out that right back side again. Then he cut back in, and, hey, he found a hole. And the next thing you know, guess what? There's another 6 points on the board. And then,
you know, it looks like he's just now picking up where he left off from last week. He's finally getting in the groove himself.
Yeah, so last week he had 3 touchdowns. This weekend he has 2. Last week, Jaden had 1 touchdown. He has 4. So it looks like we got a little competition for they're tied 5-5. By the end of the year, there may be some friendly wagers on who has the most touchdowns.
Hey, and I tell you what, I'll take that kind of competition all day long.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And I'll tell you something else. We're at 49-7 with 3:39 in the third quarter. And I can tell you the offensive coordinator's goal tonight was 600 yards of rushing and 60 points. So I think we got a chance.
So you're telling me there's a chance?
Maybe one in a million.
But there's still a chance.
There's always a chance.
I think the odds are a little higher than that.
I think so too.
All righty. So we're going to kick off from our own 25-yard line after that penalty is assessed on the kickoff. We got the wind blowing in our area. I would assume that Weston's probably either going to try to push this or he's going to try to kick that sucker just on a line right down the middle and get that thing to hop around a little bit.
We're still kicking in that wind. That's a little bit difficult. But
we're still going to boom this thing on the wind.
That's right. If you're home, we need to get your hooks up. We got to get your hooks up.
All right, here we go. Let's get this going. All right.
Boom.
Yeah, it's just a little pooch kick. Nobody's covered it. That thing landed out of bounds. I thought that wind was going to hold it up, and we were actually going to recover it because Lake Worth, they had 3 Lake Worth bullfrogs there, and it was like the Bermuda Triangle was going to land right in the middle.
None of them were paying attention to where it was, and it just happened to go out of bounds. The wind blew it out of bounds, and that's just an unfortunate mistake.
So Lake Worth is start on the 50-yard line. It's going to be on the negative side of the 50-yard line, just a hair. All right.
We've got some volleyball scores to bring you.
We'll do it right after this play there, Coach Guidry. We got twins set up on the 50-yard line. Here we go. Number 6 still at quarterback. He's going to hand it straight up the middle. He's going to – number 3 finds a little crease. He's still on his feet, still churning. He picked up about 8 yards. Go ahead, Coach Kidrick.
That was Ron Brennish there. We got varsity winning in 3 sets, 25-19, 25-17, and 25-9. Our JV went 1-2. Our freshman went 2-0, both purple and gold teams. And looks like that's a great start for our varsity softball.
We're looking like about a second and a long yard and a half here. There we go. They're going to hit. That ball's on the ground.
And we recovered.
And
we got
it. With it. There you go.
That's what we needed right there.
Number 40 comes up with the fumble recovery, which is Michael Gifford. Michael Gifford, he comes up with the fumble recovery. Pirates are a little fired up here. They're coming off. Hey, you mentioned it earlier, Coach Guidry. It's never good when you have a slippery ball.
Never good.
That thing gets up on the ground real quick. And, I mean, you know, I'm sure their hands are sweaty and stuff out here tonight, but everybody wears gloves now. I didn't even know they had receiver gloves and stuff like that when I played.
Well, sir, they also had leather sacks and on their head and no mask, which is clearly evident by your face now.
Yeah, that's true. We got the band just lighting it up below us. It's outstanding. Here we go. We got number 14 in motion. Here we go. We got a pitch. That is number... looks like 44.
That's William Moon.
William Moon.
QB in number 7.
Number 7, looks like Caden Crouch is in at QB. Number 44, William Moon is in at running back. And what did I say, number 14 was in motion? That was Trevor Granger. So we got some, looks like number 10 is out here at wide receiver. That's Sammy Estrada.
Good to get some of these seniors in, get them some work.
Yeah, I mean... you know it's going to be a number 25 in there at running back also. That's Anthony DeBello. Yeah, it's good to get them some work because you never know when you may have to count on them.
We slipped up there.
Yeah, Turf was a little slip. Turf Monster got him right there. So we got a third. We're coming up with like a 3rd and 7 right here. All right, so we got a 3rd and 7 Pirates right here. Set up in the flex bone, both seats left. Here we go, we're gonna run it right up the middle. Picked up about a yard.
About a yard.
So it'll be 4th and 6. Time. And so it looks like we're gonna run our punt team onto the field here. A minute and a half ticking in the third quarter left. Uh-oh. Look at our band.
The
our band's
got the train going.
And the roller coaster going. Cheerleaders get into it. Stowaways have got it going here. Man. Oh, we got the roller coaster going. I got to pay attention to the game. There's a snap. Here we go. Oh, we got a nice punt. That's hanging up there. He's going to try to run. Number five, I'm not sure what he was thinking. That ball hung up in the air for a long time. If I'd have been him, I probably would have just fair caught that.
I tell you what, that was a great punt into this win.
That was an excellent punt, but we have looks like we have an illegal formation or something again. So they're going to bring it back and make us punt it again.
Well, Hayden Burns hadn't had to punt a whole lot tonight, so
his legs should be fresh. Yeah. His punting legs should be fresh, but he's played a lot on defense though. So
oh, he has for sure.
He's done a good job out there too. So now it's going to be we're going to punt on 4th and 12 here. Yeah, here we go. Everybody's lined up. Uh oh. It looks like the Bullfrogs want to take a timeout. They want to set up some. I wonder if they're going to set up some shenanigans to try to get this thing run back.
Upcoming interviews.
So for some reason, sir, between this third and fourth quarter, they want to interview us. I'm not sure what they – haven't we said enough tonight?
I mean, we have the whole fourth quarter and still talk. You think that's a wise plan? I mean, we only have so many intelligent words. Maybe intelligence is not a word that should be used with us, but, you know, we only have so many words that are comprehensible.
Jimmy, no one has ever used intelligent in describing you and I, ever.
That don't usually go into conversation together.
Yeah.
All right.
Here we go, back here we go. Again.
Back out. Here we go. We're going to make a punt right here. Looks like they're going to try to overload our right side and try to get a block here. But Hayden got off another great punt. Number three, their running back coming back up. He made a great job of a running catch, and it looked like he was going to get free. Looked like he was going to get free, but somebody grabbed hold of his shoulder pad and said, we're going to hold you right here.
That looked like number 85, Carter Riley, on that tackle there.
About a 40-yard punt, so the Bullfrogs are going to start at first to 10 on their own 22. With 43 seconds left in the third quarter, trailing 49-7. Trying to run, they're trying to show a little bit of flex ball. They're going to try to run that wild. That did not.
You know,
Hoggy Zapata shot that home, shot that cap. And boy, he spun that guy around, and then that blew up the whole play.
Yeah, well, you know, Jimmy, here's the problem with that. With them running the flex defense, what do you think our guys do at practice all week long? They practice against
a flex?
A flex.
They fit it. It looks like they're gonna just. Looks like the Bullfrogs are a little beaten down, and they're just gonna let the clock run out here and go into the fourth quarter, trailing 49-7.
What's up, Pirates? I'm Cole Bradley with Pirate Sports Network, and I'm joined here today by Mr. Heffernan and Coach Gadry, who have been commentating three amazing quarters of football so far. We've had over 900 viewers so far. How does that make y'all feel?
You know, that's quite impressive that you had that many viewers, and I think it's because you haven't had the camera on us, because, I mean, look at that face. Yeah, that is made for radio, not television.
We are a face for radio, not television, that's for sure.
Yes, and so far, how has the commentating experience been?
Well, listen, we don't claim to be like David Euchre. He does a fantastic job. We're just here to try to fill his shoes, and we're just trying to have fun with it. We hope the crowd's having fun with it. I know we are.
Yeah, I mean, I ain't got much more to say than that, you know.
So, any favorite things so far from commentating?
Just getting to be out here and support our Pirates has been awesome, and just, you know, being able to shout out to all the great organizations and stuff, all the, you know, everybody that supports our Pirates, our fans, our, you know, the cheerleaders, the stowaways, the band, the trainer. I mean, dude, the list goes on and on.
And we have a unique perspective because we're in the school all day. We see these kids and we see how hard they work, and it's good to see the fruits of their labor out here on the field.
Yes, sir. And I at Pirate Productions would love to have you back, and I imagine the people at home would too. We want to know, would y'all be interested in doing this again?
Oh, absolutely. I'd love to do this again. This has been a lot of fun.
Yeah, if y'all trust us with an open mic for 3 hours, I mean, yeah, we'd do it again.
Well, thank you for the commentating. We're looking forward to one more great quarter of football. I'm Nick Cole Bradley, Mr. Heffernan, Coach Gidry. Go Pirates.
Back watching the students perform, and we got a third and one here with 10:39 and ticking for the Bullfrogs. Looks like our now. Oh, there's snap. Direct snap for number three. He's going to go around the right side. He's still on his feet fighting for some yards. He's going to have a first down. Looks like he picked up about three or four yards. He's going to pick up their first down.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Number three, Damian Hopkins, he has really run hard. He's done a good job for Lake Worth tonight. He's had some hard yardage, but he's really worked hard back there for him.
So, alright, so now here we go. Here we are. They got a first down. So now they got a first down. Clock still 10 minutes and ticking. Coach Barnes is encouraging his defense right now, rooting them on right here. Make no bones about it. It doesn't matter what the score is or where we are in the game. These coaches want to see our kids compete to the whole time. He's encouraging them and stuff.
And he has a few backups in right now, and he's trying to coach them up and get them ready to be where they need to be in the future. So, Lake Worth looks a little beaten down, but other than that,
yeah. And then we got a second and eight here coming up. They're going to step back. They're going to try to make a pass down that. Oh, yes, right there. Number 16 steps right in front of it right there. That's Emilio Rodriguez. He read that play all the way. They were going to try to do that little
spot. Oh, we got a flag.
Oh, that may be them hitting us out of bounds. But number 30-yard return by Emilio. I tell you what, the best thing about that is he didn't get fooled by the fake where they were trying to fake they're going to throw that underneath and try to hit the guy go down the sideline. He sat right there.
And ready.
And when he saw the pass, I mean, he almost looked like he was intended. He was running an out cut, and they were trying to hit him on the out cut.
And it almost looked like he knew the play.
Yeah. And so now let's see what the flag on the play was. It appears they're dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct against the Bullfrogs again.
Yeah.
You know, here's the thing. I understand things not going your way tonight, but just finish out the game. You don't need to. Uh-oh. So it's going to be first and 10 Pirates. Caden Crouch back under center. Davin Jones, it looks like, went right up in the middle.
He might have gotten a yard.
He might have got a yard, half a yard, but but the great thing about it is when you're winning 49-7, you know what that allows everybody to do?
Get involved in play.
Well, it lets everybody get involved in play on the football team, but it also allows allows all the student organizations that are out and the fans to relax a little bit and just have some fun. Do some things, have some fun, enjoy yourself.
You know, I'll tell you again, Jimmy, I'm absolutely ecstatic about our fans that showed up here tonight. I mean, we have, these stands are full.
Yeah.
And I am super proud of how we traveled. I hope that continues all season long.
I do too. There's a few people that have headed that way. There you go, a little toss to number 14. We're trying to overload them at the point of attack. Stayed in bounds. That's a good sign. So that's about on a third and 10. Nine. Looks like you picked up about four. So we're going to bring up a fourth and six. It appears that I thought we were gonna go for it, but it looks like we're gonna run the field goal team out on there. We're gonna get. Hey, you need to get a little work with your field goal team.
I like this call. This is a great idea.
I mean, it's a little bit longer than the extra point. It's having to run onto the field right here in the middle.
But we're kicking with the wind. It's gonna be fine.
Yeah. Here we go. We got 4 seconds to snap it. Snaps up. Snaps there, kicks away. It looks like he drilled it right down the middle.
That's a great job by Cantrell.
There we go. So that's going to make it 52-7. Now, Coach Guidry, here's the thing. I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay.
Coach wanted to score 60 points tonight. If you score another touchdown, I think you kick it and you just end up with your 59. I don't think you go for two and try to run that up. But
no, I don't think they're about that. I think Coach Glendo does things the right way.
and his team is disciplined, and he's disciplined, and I think he's going to do things the right way. So I don't think that's going to happen. I think if at 52 points, if that was the final score, we'd be happy with that.
Yes, I mean it's. All right. Well, you know what? You know what this gives us an opportunity to do again?
It gives us to bring that hook up.
Oh, man, we get to do the hook again. I just wish we need to teach our parents how to do the hook. We may have to have at the Spirit Rally on Wednesday night, we may have to have a learning session for all of the older people in the stands. The experienced, not older, experienced people in the stands.
Hey, there's a lot of young people down there as well.
Yeah, we had some students travel.
Age discrimination.
Wow. Well, most of them are younger than
me.
Here
we go. Get your hooks up, folks.
Boom.
Oh, that's a big kick.
Nice kick. It's driving him back. It's going to land in zone. It's going to be a touchback. All right.
So we got 7:21 left in the game.
And I know that we're going to have some interviews after the game. I think they're going to try to get a drum major or a stowaway, maybe a pirate football player, maybe a cheerleader. I think they're going to try to incorporate everybody into the interview process.
Well, you know, it's been a great night by all parties, and I think everybody should get interviewed on a game like tonight.
All right, so we got a first and 10 from the 25-yard line. Bullfrogs, looks like they're contented. It looks like, number three bounces outside. Started up the middle, bounced outside, and got a little lane to run in. He's going to have
about 18 yards there.
He's going to have about 18, 20 yards, but there's a little yellow hanky on the field, so we're going to see what, we're going to see if that, it appears they may be bringing against us.
Personal foul.
Personal foul, face mask against us. So
that's going to tack on another 15.
Yeah, after a 19-yard run, that's going to add another 15. Do the math real quick. You tell me how many yards that was.
340.
You were close. Yeah. You're close. Not bad. I mean, I realize I didn't give you a calculator before. I said you're going to have to do
math. And I didn't take off my shoes.
It'll be all right. All right. Here we go. Quarterback keeper fakes the handoff, just danced, started to go left, got turned back up the middle. Danced around, has about a gain of about 4 yards. Gonna set up about a second and six. That'll be from the Pirates' 39-yard line.
And you wonder at this point.
I think the Lake Worth Bulldogs, they've kind of resigned themselves. Let's just go do what we do and let the clock expire on us.
Now we got a false start.
They're going to get a false start, so everything they did positive on first down is just being wiped out right there. So that instead of a second and six, it's going to move it to a second and 11.
Wide receivers left here. Let's see what they do with that.
They're just going to hand it off. Number three, he broke one tackle. He's up the middle. It's a foot race in the end zone. Cuts it back to the right. And they say that he made it in. Hit him right at the goal line. He kind of spun in. Started right up the middle. Found a nice little crease up the middle. And then he bounced it out to the right side. And then it just became a foot race. And we hit him right there close to the goal line. But he kind of bounced and spun off of us over to the end zone.
Yeah, Coach Glendale's not going to be happy about that play. He wishes he could have that one back.
Yeah, you can look at Coach Barnes down there. He's got his hands on his hips. He's a little upset about that. But, you know, hey, that's a learning. That's learning. All right, we got their left-footed booter puts it through. So now we have a 52-14 game with 6:18 left in the ball game.
If you have crash, go ahead and pass it.
You know, ideally when we go back out on offense, if we could just churn out two or three first downs and just let that clock tick.
Yeah, that's what we got to do here. We got to just run out the clock. Hopefully, we do have some different guys in playing right now, but they need the experience too. They need to get the work in, and it's important that they do that.
Hey, we're gonna do a little interview with this little girl down here, so you can tell everybody down there that we're gonna mute you guys and then we'll point you.
Okay, right now.
All right, guys, we got a special interview for you down there on the sidelines. Who do we have down there?
Hey Pirates, I'm Baylor Oliver here with Pirate Sports Network, and I'm with Lily Kelly. Lily, what is your favorite thing about coming to the football games?
Seeing my friends and doing stuff with the cheerleaders.
That's so fun. Now, I see you drew something here. What is this?
It's of the cheerleaders and the flyer, and it says Go Pirates on it. They are having fun at the football stadium, and they have their pom-poms in the air.
That's awesome. Now, I see a football player right here. Do you know a football player on this team?
Yes, my brother. He's number 5, and his name is Jace.
That's so sweet of you to come support him. Okay, last question. Who do you think is going to win tonight?
Pirates, obviously.
That is awesome. Okay, I'm Baylor Oliver.
I'm Lily Kelly.
And we are signing off. Go Pirates!
You know what, Coach Guidry? I think we would have more viewers if you had her doing the commentating instead of us.
Listen, there's no question that that's probably way more entertaining to listen to than it is us.
Yeah.
I mean, and she's just precious.
So on the first down play, we gained 1 yard. So now the clock's ticking. We got a 2nd and 9. It looks like we had several men in motion in that. It looks like they're going, uh-oh. And now there's another flag on the play. Looks like we're going to get a motion penalty on us, but then it also looks like they may, number 23 on their team may get an unsportsmanlike dead ball foul, which that's a first down for us.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, this game has, games like this start to get messy.
It's deteriorated a little bit. And that's a big word for me.
Well, that is. That had a lot of syllables, sir.
I know. Don't ask me to say it again.
Or spell it.
Oh, no. No, no.
I'm proud of you for using it. Was that on a calendar at home or something, or at your desk that you had to get in a word or something?
My wife just texted me.
Okay,
she's
gotcha.
A smart lady, man.
Well, I question her judgment in men, but, you know, other than that, she's a wonderful lady. Christina, God bless you.
She came down from Kansas, and I surprised her with a little bit of charm and a little Texas hospitality, and she made a mistake.
Yeah, well, she got here, and she had some of that Kansas dust on her eyes. She couldn't see clearly.
Exactly. All right, so on 1st and 10, we're going to hand off right up the middle, number 44 again on the run. It looks like he barrels head for about 5-6 yards.
Yeah, there you go. That's kind of put your head down run right there.
That was a pretty darn good run. I mean, he barreled ahead. He was
should be about 3 yards short, 4 yards short.
Yeah, we're about 4 yards. Got a 2nd and 4 on the coming up. But the great thing is we're about to go under 5 minutes for the game left in the game.
If we can keep running plays like that, this clock won't last long.
No. We're gonna go right up the middle. They kind of stuffed us on that one. They were ready for it. Kind of stood us up, stuck us on that. That's fine.
Yeah, they read that one pretty well.
Yeah, they did. So we're going to be at a 3rd and 4.
Not even lost a yard on that one.
I hadn't seen the down marker guy move an inch, so I'm going to say that we didn't.
There we go. That's good.
Yeah. So now we're 3rd and 4, 4:22 and ticking. Oh, we got a quarterback keeper, and he's down the sideline. Look at Caden Crouch go. It's a foot race to the end zone.
And he's in.
And he's going to win that foot race. Right there, he faked that little handoff up the middle, and they all sucked in, thought we were going to try to power him again. Caden pulled that ball out, made it look like he was going to run an option, and just out racing to the end zone.
That's just another great call by Coach Otten.
Yeah. That was a great read by Kate Krause. Now, do we have Vaughn Magache and Magache again to kick the extra point this time? Yes. Trying to get set up. All right, so Vaughn's getting ready. That's our student body president also. A long kicker, and it is good.
We're good. We're good.
Right there. There you go.
4 minutes left, and we're up 59-14.
59-14.
I don't know how many yards we have in total rushing. I venture to say we're close to
We were at 291 coming out of the half, and it looks like we've...
I think we're over 200 yards in the second half as well.
Yeah, so I know we've hit the 500 mark. Now it's gonna be close. How far into the 500 mark did we get?
Hey, whatever it is, it's a great performance by our Pirates tonight.
Yeah. You know, I see Coach Naradovi down there talking to some offensive linemen. It looked like he was instructing them, and then he got to something, and it looked like he was doing a bad dance at that point. I don't know. I hope that's not on film, because.
Oh, I hope it is. I'd love to see that.
It looks like our band and everybody has their phones out with their flashlights on, waving them back and forth. Having a little fun here tonight.
Communicating with the Lake Worth band.
Oh, that, I see that. We are communicating. It's like Morse code going on over here. Oh, we got to get our hooks up. Let's not forget our hooks today.
We cannot forget our hooks at home. Everybody get your hooks up.
Here we go. Boom. Oh, it's a driven deep. Keep backing up. He's going to take it on about the 1 yard line. He's coming up right up the middle, cutting back to the left. And he's going to be taken down by number 40. That'll be Michael Gifford at the 30-yard line. Look, our cheerleaders are still chunking T-shirts and footballs into the stands after every score.
Their spirit never stops.
They're dancing for the spirit, man.
Yes, they are.
You know, the great thing is, you know, it looks like our boys, even after a big win last week, they came back, they humbled themselves. You know, as it says in Proverbs, pride comes before the fall, but humble yourself. And it was a great interview down there earlier by Baylor Audible, but you know, it looks like our boys are, you know, they're remaining humble and working hard.
Yeah, and I think that's just a testament to this new philosophy by Coach Galindo. Keep your nose down, grind it, play hard.
We got a pirate down on the field. I don't mean to interrupt you there. We got a pirate down on the field that doesn't look good. You know, there goes Coach Rankin and Coach Rhodes out there, you know. They work hard to keep the all the Pirates healthy, and that in all sports.
In all sports, they're busy several nights a week. They're another one of those unsung hero staff members that maybe don't get a lot of mention behind the scenes, but they are responsible for a lot of athletes, and they know them all, and they do a great job. I can't say enough about them and their staff, and their student trainers as well.
Yeah. Who is that's number 95? That looks like Moses. Moses Mason. He's walking off on his own. Looks like he's a little stiff-legged there. You think that possibly could be a cramp?
It might be. He may have got dead-legged on that play.
Yeah. That was a loss of one on the play. So it'll bring up a second and 11. You know, but if you look at it, as the night has gone on, you know, knock on wood, it looks like the Pirates should come out of this game pretty healthy. Their old quarterback keeper around the right side found a little room. He's going to be taken out of bounds at the just shy of the 40-yard line, which is going to be a first down.
Well, it is real important for us to come out of here healthy, and I think that's why we see some of the starters come out of here right now, because again, we start district play next week. We got Waco
district
coming.
District play and homecoming. All in the same week.
And you want everybody healthy, firing on all cylinders going into the first district game at home.
Yeah. All right, so the first and 10, 250 and counting. They're going to hand out right up the middle, number three again. He's been a workhorse tonight. He's run the ball quite a bit and done a good job. He's still running hard. Even down 59-14 with 2.5 minutes left, he's still running hard. He picked up about five there.
And that's a testament to him and him just working hard. He's a big part of their offense, and I'm sure that that this is a little frustrating for him tonight.
All right, so we got a second and five. We got a twin set. Number six, still the quarterback. Number three, still in the backfield as the running back. Snap back. We're going quarterback keeper this time. He pulled it. Thought he had it around the end, but we were sitting there on that. Looks like, who was that, number 90? Is that, that's Joshua Rose. He sealed that outside and then got a little help inside and that play was done from the start. So it looks like it was a loss of one. It's going to be third and six here. We're going a little roll out to the right. Looking for a receiver. It's just short, kind of a, just short of the intended target.
Yeah, he's left a few of those passes short tonight.
Oh, Mr. Guidry, do I see a punt team coming onto the field?
Well, sir, yes, you do.
So we may actually get to see a punt tonight. And this
well,
time.
We've seen one.
We did see one. It looks like Joshua McGinnis is going to be back to return the punt. You know, but it's always scary when the quarterback is your punter also. Because then you never know when he's just going to pull that thing down and fling one as we saw on their very first possession tonight.
Yeah, I think that's why you see Tosh Clayton back there kind of hanging back just a little bit.
Looks like the Lake Worth Bullfrogs took a timeout before the play clock expired on them. So with 1:32 to go in this game, it's a 59-14 lead for your Granbury Pirates with the 4th and 6 coming up for the Bullfrogs.
So let's talk about next week. What do you think about homecoming?
Well, you know, the Waco Lions, they're always an interesting bunch because, you know, they usually have some athletes that can play a little bit. But, you know, it's up and down. So, you know, from year to year, some years they have some pretty good teams. 2 years ago, they had a little quarterback that, whoo, he was tough.
Yeah.
He was tough. Last year, they were down a little bit and struggled a little bit. So I haven't got a scouting report on them this year, so it'll be interesting to see. But, you know, I bet our Pirates come out and play them hard at homecoming.
Yeah, I think Coach Glenda will definitely have them ready to play.
Yeah. So here we go with the 4th and 6 play. We're going to snap it back. He is going to punt it. Little pooch punt there. McGinnis catches it on the run, and he is going to return it all the way back to their 40-yard line. That was passed there, but there is a flag on the play. I don't know if that's going to be holding or blocking below the waist or what we've got.
That was actually their quarterback and punter, yeah, Jose Meza, that made that.
Yeah, we're gonna get a hold on the Granbury Pirates at about our own 47. So that looks like they're gonna bring it back about 10, you know, yeah, about 10 yards from there. So we'll probably start on our own 37, I imagine.
Well, with 1:22 left in the game, I think that.
I see Jaden Rogers is hanging back about the 25-yard line, which that usually tells me we're probably going to run the victory formation, take a couple of knees, and
watch this clock run out,
and take the win at a 59-14.
Well, Jimmy, has commentating been everything that you wanted it to be tonight? I mean, I think that you know the. We downed it there. Our first time, listen, maybe a rough start, maybe not doing the greatest job. I mean, hats off to you, for he does a great job with all this. And so, but I've had a lot of fun, even though it was with you. And maybe we can do it again sometime.
Yeah, maybe they'll call us back sometime and say, hey, y'all want to do that? And they'll probably give us some pointers. They're probably going to review our tape and give us some pointers and stuff on this.
They don't have that much time on their hands. No one does, okay?
Yeah, I mean, listen. I said a few. I didn't say they're going to give us all the pointers that need.
No one has that kind of time.
All right, so we got, we're going to take a knee, and that should do it. Well, it's been a great night here at the Lake Worth Bullfrog Pond. You know, at the old Frog Pond, it's been a good night for the Granbury Pirates.
Final score, 59-14.
Yeah. Oh. 59. All right, so we're going to shake hands here as the time ticks off. Coach Glendo's going to go shake the Bullfrog coach.
Post-game interview with Jaden Rogers and Glendo.
All right. So
y'all stay tuned for our post-game interviews. We're going to have Jaden Rogers and Coach Glendo. We look forward to hearing from them.
And thank y'all for tuning in to Pirate Production Studios for a great night of Pirate football. Signing off.
Jaden, amazing tonight. The 5 touchdowns you had in your performance.
To be honest, I didn't know I had 5, but that's crazy. I mean, straight from the O-line, receivers, slots, quarterbacks. You know, this new offense that we've been doing, we're getting it slowly and surely, but it's gonna keep doing good things, and playoffs is the goal. So,
I can tell y'all been putting in the work. What are you looking forward to this season?
Looking forward to, again, playoffs. That's our main goal as a team, and so we're gonna keep doing everything we can, everything in our power to do that.
Thank you so much. My name's Aiden Jordan, signing off with Pirate Sports Network.
Sweet, I got my hands.
Oh, my bad. No, that's good.
What's up, Pirate Nation? My name is Aiden Jordan. Here joined with me tonight is Coach Galindo. Coach, how do you feel about your second straight win?
I feel good for the kids. The kids deserved what happened tonight. We feel like we outwork our opponents week in and week out. We want to be smarter as far as preparing for the victories and being coachable. And then certainly we want to leave the field the toughest team out there. And I feel like we did that. Very deserved, I think, for the kids.
Thank you, Coach. And for my second question, how does the team look so far?
So far, we look good. You know, the new offense took a while to learn. Defense was kind of what we've been doing, so they were comfortable. The offense is getting more comfortable. We just need to clean up some penalties and some mistakes that we keep making.
Thank you, Coach. And for my third question, is there anything we can expect coming up in the next few weeks?
Not anything more than the teams are going to get tougher from here on. We start district next week. There's a lot of good teams in that district that have a tradition and history. We're just going to take care of what we do and see what happens.
Thank you so much, Coach. My name is Aiden Jordan, signing off with Pirate Sports Network.
Thank you, Aiden.